perfectly, Kim. Okay, dude, your photography is off the fucking rails. Okay, this guy is gonna be the next wristwatch photographer. Okay, he's gonna be like the, you know, the waitlisted guy the other guy. Yeah. Hey.
Hey.
We got cheers. Two scotch and soda. I ordered scotch and soda. This looks like scotch on the rocks to me.
It's not.
You don't like it?
No.
I'll drink yours, and then we can order something else for you.
No.
You're good? You're good?
Good.
Okay, he's good. Guys, Tim Wright here, joined by SmallG. Check him out on Instagram. We're here just at the Folly Bar. We're getting a drink, and in like 25 minutes, we're going to head over to the Soho Leica shop for an exhibition to watch a photography presentation. Have you ever been to a photography presentation? I know, right?
First time.
Yeah. I'm excited.
First time.
Yo.
Thank you, Markus.
Markus. And you connected with him.
Yeah, it's from FPJ.
Yeah. Ah. FPJ so
event.
Did you see him first on my live stream and then you...
No.
Oh, no.
Before, right? Far before.
He jumped on yours. Wow. Really?
Yeah, we know each other for a long time.
That's crazy, man. And now he's kind of getting...
Small world.
It is really, really small world, guys.
Small
Watch world of watches. You know what? This whole thing that there's too many watches, that's a little bit overblown. It's not enough watches, actually, right? There's so many people out there, 8 billion people.
Yeah.
1 million watches is nothing for 1 billion people. Shout out to the watch community. We got so many cool guys here in the chat. Shout out to OC. We've got Monkey Fart. Okay, let's just hide that user in the thing. Okay, taken care of.
Who is that?
I don't know. It's just some. Look, it is what it is. Hey, we got Hoff on Smash in the chat. Shout out to Hoff on Smash. He says, damn, would have liked to check that out. Love Leica store in Soho. Secretly want M so bad.
You should come right now.
Come right now.
We have time.
It's until 8.
Yeah.
I mean, if he's already...
Save
him. He's Long Island. He's like with Buckley over there. It's far. I didn't know he would want to come. I told Buckley. Buckley said, you don't want me there. Because I'm going to freaking explode. I'm going to say how these photographs are boring and this bullshit. And I'm like, okay. Well, Buckley, you got to go in with an open mind, an open heart. And Buckley, it's hard. Sometimes it's hard not to say how you really feel, but exploring new things is cool.
But Buckley doesn't like it. It's too nerdy.
Too nerdy?
Too nerdy to him.
Yeah, I know. But this is, we're doing it for a friend as well, Markus.
We want to support a friend.
This is more special than seeing some douchebag who's already at the top of his career, right? The guy who already made it, he doesn't care. He's just like, look at my art. Feast your eyes, right? But this is more real. He's there.
Yeah, 10 million each, right?
Yeah, I know, right? I bought one of the prints.
Show me.
Yeah, and actually, the earthquake kit.
Are you an influencer? What's happening?
Oh, yeah. We're kind of, I'm a watch influencer.
He's a
wristwatch
YouTuber.
Wristwatch YouTuber, live streamer. Kind of, yeah, if you like wristwatch. Oh yeah, it is like a completely different. Here, I'll give you my card.
Watch YouTuber.
Yeah, wristwatches. You like wristwatches? No, not yet. Maybe.
Oh, so like TikToks that I see where they do watches.
Yeah, but they buy sell. I just talk about them. I love watches, and we kind of discussed. Today we discussed the Rolex released new models, and we were talking about what the teaser is trying to suggest. I think we broke the code. It's like Rolex is like Illuminati. They got secret codes and stuff.
This stranger doesn't know what you're talking about.
Well, I like watches. So
do you know Rolex? Do you know Rolex?
Of course.
You want to join us on the stream over here?
Yeah, come in here.
No, get in.
No.
No? Okay.
I'm hiding. I don't
want anybody. Oh, I mean, who's? Don't be shy. We
I'm
don't
not
bite.
Shy, but I'm like working on.
Oh yeah. I got you. You gotta be careful. Guys, upload the live stream. We're going to see the art exhibition right now. It's gonna be very cool at the Leica shop. Well, by the way, if there's people who are interested in photography exhibit, it's gonna be in like 20 minutes. It's about the climb to a Kilimanjaro, and the gentleman took all the pictures during his climb to Kilimanjaro with his grandfather's camera, his grandfather's Leica camera. So, cool. Yeah.
Super cool.
You know?
Yeah.
So, his it's exciting.
Leica. Yeah. Super cool. He used his grandfather's Leica to take a picture.
Yeah.
That's already amazing.
Right? It's more special because it's like...
Very special.
You can get any camera you want. You can get the high... You can go with the Hasselblad, right?
Exactly.
But that's... Well, you're telling a story here. And he took the pictures in the style that his grandfather was taking pictures. Shout out to Humble Pine.
Shout
says,
Humble Pie, yes.
Tim and Small G enjoy the show and have a drink for me. Cheers to Humble Pine. We need soju for Humble Pine.
Humble cheers. Pie, cheers.
The legend that is Humble Pine. I met him in DC a couple of days ago.
How was that?
Oh, life changing. Dude, there's... I sound like an idiot, but seeing sunrise in DC changed my life. It transformed it. Flipped it upside down.
Humble Pie is very nice. The nicest guy in the world.
Oh man.
Huge supporter.
He took care of me.
You cannot do this without him.
I can't afford going to DC.
No.
Right? I mean, he took care of me there. He got me a dinner and breakfast for me in the roommate too.
Oh my goodness.
I have to. When he comes back to New York, I gotta treat him because he's done so much for me. He's a true loyal supporter. Cheers to Humble Pine again. Amazing. Man. Scotch and soda. This is Humble Pine. He gets vodka soda all the time. That's his like bar signature drink.
Okay.
He asked me over there when I was going downstairs to the restroom.
Yeah.
He asked me like, do you want it on the, you said on the rocks? And I said, no. Scotch and soda with ice. And he said, okay, gotcha. And then he came up with this. It's on the rocks. I said, no, not on the... Whatever. It's okay. I'm not mad. Sometimes you just gotta take what the universe throws at you and just have fun with it. So, yeah.
What are you wearing?
Oh, I'm wearing two watches.
Oh my goodness.
I got the Grossman. You wanna see? Did you see the Grossman?
I did.
Okay. You wanna see it again?
Well, I'm good.
Are you good? Okay. Good. What is this?
You're a panda.
Yeah. My panda. And I got Daniel Kat Ming.
Oh.
Yeah. Check it out.
Nice. Check it out.
Yeah. Let me you need to see this. This is gonna. I wore two watches, guys. Check it out. This is a special one. Yeah.
Very nice. I like it a lot.
It is cool.
Yeah, it's very cool.
It's a Ming. Not a lot of people have Mings, like Mings. Well, actually, they were hyped when I started the show. In fact, this might have been one of the first watches that we were kind of discovering on the live streams. Whoa, Scotty H, $5 super chat. He says he PayPal'd. Okay, you know what? I'm gonna unblock the thing. Okay, let me see. Thank you so much, Scotty H, for $15 PayPal donation. Really appreciate it. Cheers to Scotty H. Legend. And this guy is always like throwing me a little PayPal here and there. It really helps out. I wouldn't be able to do this stuff, guys. And I'm really doing it for you. I really want to do this type of content for you guys to bring you to all these interesting things that I consider interesting. I think they're not like... But the world things, right? It's a humble thing.
Yeah.
But I think there's heart and soul in this, so that you can't get, you know, over there, because it's all the doors are locked, right? There you have to be, you have to say the right, right? You have to toe the right agenda with the other guys. But here we're gonna be a little more liberated. And you know,
what?
I'm so fucking grateful that you came here, okay? Because bro. I could see you exhibiting in that shop. Yeah, not like next, but like you have to talk to these guys how to get the prints and how to set it up. And we're all gonna come. We can do it like around, you know, like sometime. Dude, imagine if we have a 2-hour exhibition right here, 2-hour exhibition, and then we all go to dinner with the watch community. Like that could be an event that we could schedule. Do a photography, you can actually, do secret photography, don't share it on the Instagram, and then these are never before seen prints.
Okay.
To shock us with.
We learn.
Yeah. We're learning this stuff, you know? Because like dude,
What's Mark's secret project?
Mark's secret project?
You doing anything like behind the scene, like what this is the first step, right?
With the photography?
Yeah.
I think he likes photography, but he also likes like directing.
Movie, right? He make a lot of
about watches.
Movie, talking watches.
I saw his perpetual time.
Yeah.
What's it called?
Perpetual time. Yeah.
Perpetual time. Yeah.
PPT. What is that called? Perpetual time something.
Yeah, perpetual time studios. I think perpetual time studios. I'm still getting used to remembering it. Evan G says, I've finally been able to show you how much better Fuji is that Canon garbage. Hey, I brought my Canon with me. Fuji is very stylistic, right? It's the
Japanese. Fuji's great.
Yeah. It's not nothing wrong with Fuji. It's Japanese top brand.
No camera is bad.
I think Fuji is. Yeah.
As long as you know how to use that.
Yeah. Oh, damn. What is this?
It's my Leica.
Oh, that's the Q2.
Yeah.
Let me see this Leica. This is the camera that you take all the pictures with.
Right.
As you guys can see here, small G's Leica camera right there. The Q2. Now, a lot of people, the new one came out, Q3. With the tilting screen and slightly modified.
Q3 is better, but a lot more expensive.
A lot more expensive.
Yeah. Yeah. You can get your good money for this one, and it's very similar camera. The same lens, just 40,
40, 45
million pixel.
40, oh, okay. So it's a higher resolution?
60 million is the Q3, I guess.
So this one is 45 megapixels, the new one is 60 megapixels.
But the same lens, everything's the same.
Ah, interesting. Yeah. So it's a new sensor in there.
Right.
And the new tilty screen.
Right.
And it's got like the capability to, and I think it's got different ports here, like a different, it's got a USB-C transfer. That's a pretty cool feature, but hey, this is it worth paying? Like, how much does this cost?
I paid $2,000.
Okay, so that was you. I know I've been telling this story on the street. Oh, look at this. Okay, he's getting ready. So what happened was I knew somebody, because like I know you have Leica and Negroni has Leica. I forgot which one of you two got his for $2,000. You got this particular guy.
Listen, I got this from a friend, so he gave me a good price.
Man,
hey,
you're really lucky.
Here.
Yo, is that Ryan?
Come on, man.
Yo, get in here.
Come see and meet up. Order a drink.
Bro.
Let me go grab a drink.
Yeah. Okay.
You got whiskey?
Yeah. But, yeah.
We got whiskey and soda.
No, we got to go in like 15 minutes. Yeah, there's no rush. We're going to be there first.
I mean, for 2,000 something. This is a bargain.
It's a bargain of a life. It's a bargain of a century. Are you kidding me?
Are you kidding
me?
Dude,
what the fuck? This is a no-brainer. Someone was selling a Q2.
$2,000?
Oh, no. Someone was selling recently a Q2 on Instagram.
Yeah.
I reached out to them. I said, how much?
And he said, $4,900.
He said, $3,500. Oh. I said, my friend got it for two. He said, wow, this is the going rate. I'm like, okay, fine, whatever. But hey, man, if you're ever selling this one, give me first dibs, because you know me, I fucking love Leica. I don't own Leica, I have the...
Ask Negroni
selling his for three, like fair price.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, he's not selling it on the cheap. No, Negroni's not gonna give me a discount. But like, hey, if you're selling this one for two, I'll buy it for two. In the future, not right now. Right now, I'm fucking broke as poking. I need to sell that sermon. I need to get the sermon out of my life.
You sell it to Carl Ken, right?
I don't know if he wants it. Hoffman Smash says 2,000 is a steal for Q2. Yeah, it is. It's a theft. So Small G got this one for $2,000. What a fucking...
Yeah, $2,000.
Did he give you the strap too?
No, this is
yours.
Yours.
Okay. And what about the grip? You put the grip?
He put a grip. Everything.
He put the grip, so you got it for free.
Yeah,
so,
for free.
Okay, it's a little bit loose. We'll tighten it up in the shop, okay? Wow, this is a pretty cool camera. What do you think, guys? Do I look cool with the Leica? Markus, he was walking around with like a Leica M10.
Yeah.
Yo, bro, it's And he's got the Richard Mille. Have you seen that Richard Mille yet?
No.
Oh, you're gonna fucking love it, man. You should have brought your FB Jorn.
Yeah, it's okay. FB Jorn is nothing.
Yeah, okay.
Not comparable.
Hey, yo, come in here. Get in here, bro. Get in here.
Hey.
Run! You want to be on camera? You don't want to be on camera?
He's okay for that.
He's shy. Yeah. Your hair looks fantastic.
Hey bro, you got my credit card, right? Pay for this.
Yeah, tell me what you want.
Everything.
Oh, you're ready?
Yeah, put on that credit card.
Yeah, I got you.
Oh, thank you. Yeah.
Did you get my card?
Yeah.
What's the name on it?
Well, I already paid.
All right.
Yeah, I closed
it. Oh.
I like your glasses.
Oh, thanks. Appreciate it.
That's very strong glasses. Yeah. I think I wore similar glasses.
Like you do watches, right?
Yeah.
She's got a watch.
Oh, yeah?
Come on in.
Bring it in.
Apple Watch. Okay, all right. You got an Apple Watch. Do you know anything about... What's your favorite, like, watch brand from watches?
I don't know much about watches.
What's the best watch that you know? Can you name the best brand? Number
Rolex.
One? Okay, that's a good guess. That's a very good guess. Okay. We're celebrating you today. Rolex teaser was announced. New Rolex watches. If you go to Rolex's Instagram or their YouTube channel, you'll see like a sneak peek preview of the watches that are to come next week at the Watches and Wonders. So we're gonna be going to Watches and Wonders and presenting all the new watches. If you guys need recommendations to buy like a proper automatic mechanical watch, that's kind of what I do. I help people out and attract to good watches. I used to have Apple Watch just like that. That's how I started. It broke down, and then I was like, man, I need a real watch. And then now I'm stuck with like some stuff. He has a good watch. You'll understand. That's a Rolex right here. See?
Is that a Rolex?
Yeah. That's a Rolex, yeah.
I've never seen a Rolex like
that. Okay. This is called a Daytona.
Oh, it's kind of beautiful, actually.
Yeah, you like it?
Nice,
yeah, check it out.
I see it.
I have, this is a Maurice Grossman. It's like a handmade watch.
Are you guys on live?
Yeah, we're live. Yeah. What's your name?
Jess.
Nice to meet you,
nice
Jess.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
So you don't know anything about watches?
No.
Okay. But hey, check that out. If somebody ever in your life needs advice.
My dad likes watches.
Okay,
so.
Send him up. Send him to our way, okay? If he's got nothing to do, we talk watches all day long.
I have a fossil watch. Right, Dallas, Texas.
Yeah.
Before I moved to New York, so that had to be around 93, 94.
Yeah, fossil is horrible. Right?
And it's a big one. It's got the wide.
No.
I want to send you a picture.
Okay, send me a picture. You got my Instagram, okay?
Yeah.
Send me a picture. Can I show your sunglasses or your glasses on the thing? No. You want to be on camera?
I never take them off.
Okay. Hey, check it out.
Prescription.
Say hi. Okay.
Prescription. Yeah, they're
ready
for me.
There we go. Check it out. Look at his glass. I think Sean has very similar ones. It's our friend. You're not gonna get it. They'll know. I think
they'll know.
I mean,
it's a mirror on it, and they figured out a way to transition a mirror.
Uh-huh.
And they put a color underneath, so that's why it just depends on the lighting. But there's a blue underneath. It's a thinnest mirror. I didn't know mirrors come in varying grades. It's the thinnest mirror, so it'll transition. And it's on my face all the time.
You see, because you can see it's like red and green playing in there. Yeah, it's pretty cool. I mean, it's fine. You could do it over here, Ryan. But yeah, we'll try not to get you caught. Yeah, so cool. I don't mind it. I don't mind it. Yeah, you could do it. I don't mind it. Okay. Let's see it.
You have been talking watches. So you have been not talking watches for 4 months.
I've been talking watches the whole time. I was just busy with something else, man. You know, there was a thing I needed to take care of. I didn't know what was happening. You know, I was so.
We're gonna talk about that.
Oh yeah. Well, yeah. All right, guys. If you guys have any questions, actually, OC's got like a fucking million questions for you, SmallG.
What
do you say? Roommate is in the chat, says, hello, SmallG, what are you wearing? He's got a Panda Daytona, roommate. Yeah, and OC says, SmallG, be careful, roommate wants to play Boom Boom Steel with your collection. Look, roommate wants to play this game where she borrows your watch.
Okay.
Or she'll give you a Pepsi in return. So you trade a watch with the roommate for a month.
Oh,
A month, whole month, yeah.
And then she gonna scratch that?
Of course. Not on purpose. There's gonna be no intentional damage, okay? No, no, not that you have to play. You don't have to play. I'm just explaining the rules of the game, okay? Yeah. It's gonna get beat to shit the roommate way, or the only the way the roommate can, right? In a month time.
You see my watch, right? My watch
is immaculate,
pristine,
yeah.
Pristine condition.
She wants to borrow your AP.
No,
that's
no,
the
no,
good
no,
one.
No, no, no. 100% no.
Yeah, I know, I know. I told her that's the stupidest game I ever heard in my life. What were you thinking? She's like, no.
No, no, no.
It's smart. No, no, no. That's not how this. I don't get it. I don't get it.
Yeah.
No. What I do understand is upvotes, guys, and we need 100 upvotes. We need 100 people in the chat watching the stream before we go. We head over to Markus and watch the exhibition.
Yeah,
this is pretty cool. I'm fucking excited, man. Cheers. What did you think about the Rolex predictions? The trailer.
Excited.
You excited?
Yeah, it's exciting.
What did you watch? A different YouTuber's predictions. What do you think?
Of course, you guys the best.
Yeah,
100%.
Rose gold, Day Date, Sky Dweller, presidential Sky Dweller, Sky Dweller, presidential, solid gold, open case back. Boom! That's the watch that's gonna be released. Oh my God! Speedy Hernandez, $20 super chat. Buy SmallG another drink because he's the man, despite the Rolex on his wrist. Yo!
Cheers!
Shout out to Speedy Hernandez. Speedy Hernandez is a cool guy. I'm not allowed to say who he is, but he's a very cool guy in the watch space. Really well known, very well respected. You don't even know him, but he's a cool guy. Thank you. Hey, can I buy you a drink? Can I actually buy you that drink?
We'll do it later.
Okay, so you just tell me when you need a drink. Just say, Timmy, buy me a drink.
Almost gone.
I'm wearing two. Whoa, John Pitcher. $20 again. Here's another one. Thank you. Holy shit. Cheers. I might need another drink because this is a watch event. Well, you need
another drink.
It's a photography event. You need at least two drinks in you.
No. We don't. We should not drink.
We should not? Why?
Because it's a...
Respected.
Yeah, quiet. Respected,
okay.
Quiet.
But I think there's going to be cocktails then.
You sure?
Oh, yeah.
I don't know.
Okay.
There might be.
I don't know.
It needs to be drunk.
First time.
Ryan is a photographer. This is totally your alley. Used to be. Okay. Ryan, what you need to do, you need to give Markus some good advice. Like, how to...
pictures look great. I love this stuff.
I bought a print.
I saw it. It's pretty
stuff's pretty neat.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It is. It is really fucking cool.
He put a lot of effort.
Oh my God.
Tons of effort. For sure.
He's like a workaholic.
You've been in his studio before, right? What do you think? He's pretty young.
Right?
Young guy.
He's
like
20 something. He's pretty young.
Very young guy.
Do you know
how
old is he?
Huh?
Do you know how old?
No. I think he's like late 20s. Yeah, Ming Shedder. No, it's a really cool. It's on the wrong side of the cool board. There you go. What is that? What is that?
It's just different.
I don't even know what that is.
It's an Omega.
It's an Omega? What the frick? I'm gonna zoom it in. Let's zoom it in here. Here we go. We're gonna zoom it in, guys. Flip the camera. Check this out. Also, shout out to Mikey for £10 super chat. Yo, Timmy and Small G, looking forward to this one. Watches and Leicas. Have a great weekend. Thank you so much, Mikey. By the way, there are Leica watches in there, so we're gonna show those as well. Look at this. Ryan, where the heck did he get this one? What an odd oddity. Look at this. That's a... Look at this. That's a bracelet from the 1908. Oh, can I get a scotch and soda? What about you? Oh, I'll have one. Maybe not? No more drinks? You want one more? No, actually, no, that's it. Yeah, that's it. We'll have one afterwards. Otherwise, it's going to be way too blasted. All right, so... I'm just joking. Yo, you just gotta have some fun with this, guys.
It's not expensive, you know. It's
wow.
Nothing crazy, but, you know,
It's cool shit, man. It's, we're never seeing stuff like this. When do we get to see crazy cool watches like this, huh? Never. Look at that. Dynamic.
Dial, right? Yeah, it's pretty special.
Is it work, the chronograph?
Yeah, everything works.
Okay, let's try it on. Boom.
They should have the open.
Boom, system. It works.
Yeah. I don't know what the boom is.
All right.
Wipe it here.
Hopefully you're okay with micro scratches.
Like, you know, $2,000 budget, very cool. Nothing expensive, but very different.
It is different, man.
But I love the bracelet.
Oh, the bracelet is bonkers.
Yeah, it's almost like a Rolex bracelet.
Yeah.
This is nice. Look at this bracelet, guys. It's what's up. The bracelet is what's up. Okay? It's serious stuff.
Not totally vintage just yet, but...
Yeah. Whoa,
it's
the...
like mid-90s when I was in high school, I wanted.
You bought this when you were in high
school? I wanted one in high school, and then eventually as an adult, I just bought one just to have it.
Oh, I see. Dude, I mean, it's a cool watch. Look at this small G.
Different.
It's nice. It's really nice. Did you want...
If you want a chronograph from Omega, you know, your choices are in your social media.
Pretty obvious, yeah. But that's a nice fit. Look at that. Whoa.
It's like 38.5.
Yeah.
It's new thing. I could see where the 3861 bracelet inspiration came from. It's
yeah,
right here.
Yeah, exactly.
Right?
Right.
It's vintage, but like you could feel how solid it is. Small G. That's what it's called.
Small G.
Small G.
Small wrist.
Yeah,
that's
different.
My wrist is only bigger than Diego.
Cheers.
What size is your wrist?
Six and a half inch wrist. Man, I got my Maurice Grossman on this one wrist. You guys would see the Maurice Grossman? Seen it before. Yeah, it's okay. It's fine. The price keeps dropping. It just cracks me up. Seeing a motor listing every week, like 1,000 cheaper.
You should sell that. You should sell that.
It's my signature watch at this point, man. It's like...
You should get an AP. You sell this, get an AP instead.
One day,
nobody's gonna sell me AP.
No, get an AP from a great market.
You got 20, 30,000, you got almost 30 grand on your wrist.
Yeah.
One day when you need it,
30
you
grand.
Consolidated it to something.
Exactly, 30 grand is a lot.
Maybe one day when it goes to 20,
it's not gonna.
It's still 20 grand. You put towards something else, or you keep
it. Yeah, I listen.
Just wear it a lot, so you get that value out of it while you have it.
Yeah, when time comes, it will sell. When the time is right.
It sells for
right.
10 grand less. It's like he had it for 2 years. You paid 10 grand to have it.
Yeah,
it's
exactly.
Like basic. Right. It's cost of ownership.
Boom.
That wears really nice.
Right. It's the Daniel Katz Ming. This one actually won GPSG award back in the early days. This is a stamped gear shed.
Did you overpay this?
No, I got it for $2,000.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Nice.
I think at the height, these were going for like $5,000.
I know, right?
Insane, right? People were... But this is still one of the earliest Mings that got any traction.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So... GPSG award for this thing is...
It's interesting. Ming doesn't come out with any new watch anymore.
Ming?
Yeah. Have you heard? No. It's been a while.
I think they're back catalog. They're
I think they are.
They reached full market saturation. They need to start cutting production.
Right.
Yeah. They need to start doing, again, like
small quantity.
Yeah, back to shedders. They've been like out of control. They've been making $30,000-$40,000 watches.
Yeah.
For Ming, are you
right.
Smoking cocaine? Seriously. Ming needs to relax. Take a step back.
Yeah, that's a little crazy.
You know?
Think of what else you could buy before you
$30,000. Kidding me? Yeah. We're gonna buy an AP.
At the bottom.
Exactly, right. What people saying.
36D, so what says, love the Omega. super duper. It's super duper. That's a nice thing.
I'll take it.
Super duper. Super duper, baby. It's good. Oh, the roommate is asking. Oh, what is this?
Food. Wow.
Oh my god.
What is this?
Shots? Oh my god.
Oh my goodness.
No way.
See, you should come to the Folly frequently and go live. And you go live from the Folly every, you know. We'll pop in, pop out, and we.
Yeah.
I like
guys,
it.
Guys, I was cheers. Looking. I was the Folly, guys. Cheers.
Cheers.
To the Folly.
She wasn't sure if you guys wanted to close or you guys going to kick it for a little bit longer.
No, we need to close.
All right.
We're heading over.
Leica.
Thank you so much, man.
Of course.
I was looking for, because McSorley's, they used to have a kind of a thing like this. 31,
I'm just going to put it here.
Mm-hmm. And they shut down. They don't have the outside sitting anymore. You know, and I like the outside sitting. To do a live stream, it needs to be outside sitting. You go indoors.
Yeah, the light is great. And oh, there's action.
Yeah,
there's
we can
energy.
Smoke here. Yeah.
I
love this spot.
I love this.
The fact that Leica's over there, that you can get amazing food. This is it. This is our new watch community hangout space.
Awesome.
Okay?
Yeah.
Thank you so much for the
gentlemen,
drinks.
Have fun.
Really appreciate
nice
it,
weekend.
Man. Thank you. What a cool guy.
Yeah.
Folly, everybody. What a place. Yeah, no, he's very
here's
cool.
A drink.
Huh?
You ordered another one, right?
No, I didn't. I said, I figured, you know, Ryan said the right thing. Don't get wasted. They might have drinks over there, so why are we spending money here? They might have unlimited free drinks. Buckley, we just had an aftershock. Oh, what about the earthquake? Wait.
I didn't feel it.
You didn't feel it?
I swear to God.
It's the largest.
Yeah,
I think it's the largest in this 15 years.
I didn't feel anything. Everyone else I knew said so they felt like majorly.
Yo,
it's huge.
I think it's a conspiracy. It happened in Lebanon, New Jersey.
No.
Maybe it was like,
dude, I was in the Leica store. You understand? I came here early for breakfast. I had a breakfast over there at Saddles. And then
so
we walk up.
Yeah, it's great.
Yeah, and we walk across the street to the Leica store to get like a sneak preview for a friend of ours. I'll tell you who it is at later. And we go across. We check out the pictures. He gives us a little preview. He's talking to, you know, Markus was talking to the guys who are setting this up for him. They're arguing about whether to put the titles underneath and stuff. I'm like, okay, yeah, it's cool. This is a very, you know, cool thing to see. And it kind of happened, the behind the scenes. And then, you know, I walk over and they sell prints there. He has some prints. If people are really inspired, they can buy a print from him. And I was looking, they have like, the big one is like 300, the small one is like, the medium one is like 150, and the small one is $75. So I'm like, oh, you know what? I'm gonna buy it. So I pick it up. So actually I walk over to him and like trying to pick it up. And then, so when I realize that I want to buy it, and then start walking to, earthquake happens. And the guys in the Leica store, they say, there's no trains here. I'm like, what do you mean?
Yeah.
There's no trains here. Oh, shit.
Shaking so much.
This guy is going to shake up the world. Okay? That's the message that the universe is sending. Okay?
This guy
so
has a lot of adventure.
I immediately knew I have to buy it. Okay?
It'll be the last thing you ever buy.
Never know. I'm going to hang it up. And it's a climb to the Kilimanjaro. The painting, the picture is off the climb to Kilimanjaro, and there's like people who are carrying all this stuff. And to me, I think like, hey, this is watch community, okay? Like, I might be doing the live stream, but the chat and the people who are watching, they're doing all the heavy lifting. So it's like we're together trying to build this watch community, and that picture inspired me. So, and Kilimanjaro, think about this, the biggest mountain, or is it the biggest, second biggest? Biggest mountain in Africa where life started, okay? That's probably where the biggest earthquake happened to make that mountain. So to me, it's like all this comes together. Hey, look, say what it is. Look, I want to make this show more meaningful than actually people find it to be. And I think this is going to be a very special event, okay?
Yeah.
Here you go, this camera. Huh?
No edibles?
No, I was just doing an event. Just doing an event. Doing a show. We're doing a show, guys. Oh, this is a live stream. Right? We're going to put on a bit of a show. So I'm excited.
Yeah, that's awesome.
I got it from a brand.
Fuji X Pro 1.
Oh,
yeah,
that's a good
just
one.
Like
that's a good
the
one.
Older one.
Yes. Fuji is a good camera.
Yeah, it looks just like this.
I wouldn't ever buy this if it's not.
Yo, Mathis. You're crazy.
My friend sold it to me.
Mathis, you're crazy.
And then it's a good camera.
Boy, Tim spins some weird stories. This is truth. I'm not making anything up. I wish this was I was making stuff up, but the more I do these streams, the more I understand the world, how the world works. It was the world, it was the universe sending a message. Anyways,
I still have some too.
Give Tim three drinks.
If you don't use that, that's just.
Peakline says OC must be out since I'm not banned anymore. Peakline, why were you banned? And then we got APIZ saying Leica. Yeah, Leicas. And shout out to Daniel Katz. Make shoe more meaningful than cat. I don't get it. What does that mean? Make shoe more meaningful than cat. It's a pun. It's a play on words.
My shoes. Yeah. So he got inspired by my shoes, which is this.
Ah.
And
he purchased two of them.
Oh, really?
Two of this.
That's cool, huh?
He got inspired by me.
In Vegas?
In Vegas. Yeah.
Really? Let's do shoe comparison. Let's do shoe comparison here. Here we go. Guys, let's do shoe comparison.
Yeah,
right.
Hey. Collaboration with Nike.
Hey.
AK is a Nike.
Let's go with the Ryan Singer first. What are those shoes? Tell us. These don't look nice.
No clue. They're old.
Signature, but I like them. I like that the stretchy part. These are very stylish, very easy to wear. These are, look at this, suede. But it's a sneaker. How does that work?
Sneaker, yeah. It's a combination.
It's a classy sneaker.
Yeah, it's very comfortable. Shoes, yeah.
And then I'm wearing Hoka. The Hokas because you know I need a little bit of help. This is about
same,
2 inches.
Same as our president.
With these shoes, I'm 5'9".
The president wear this.
Oh yeah, exactly. Biden was spotted wearing the Hokas, man. Because you never know. I mean, you need that support. That support is great. I think we gotta go. Is it good? Let's go. Everybody's cool.
Oh wow.
Shout out to. The Folly, everybody. What happened?
There is another
another earthquake?
Yeah.
No. This guy's running really fast. I wonder what happened. Okay. The Folly. Don't be a victim to an earthquake, guys. New York City, Soho area. We got a Cartier ad right there on top of the building. As you can see, Cartier celebrating the Trinity 100 years. There's a clue ad. This is a very luxurious area. Oh, St. Laurent. Dang. Shout out to Father Artifact for $28 donation. Keep bringing the great content, Tim. Father Artifact, thank you so much for joining me tonight on this live stream. Hopefully you guys will enjoy it. It's something different. It's something, I think, a little bit more unique. It's something watch community niche. This is why we do this stuff. Check out this. The sunset here is incredible. It's happening. It's perfect weather. Look at that BMW. Shout out to Sean. My hair is a total mess, but it is what it is. Small G and Ryan, they're right behind me. Let's go find out what this thing is all about, guys. This is a wristwatch enthusiast putting on a photography show of his journey to Mount Kilimanjaro with his grandfather's camera. You guys, it's gonna be incredible. Get ready. I think it's right there behind some of those flags. There's the Leica flag. Oh, where did I have breakfast earlier? I think, Saddles. That's where we had breakfast earlier today. It's a really good spot, guys. They make fresh bagels right there. Saddles. Okay. We gotta be cool. I don't know if he said he doesn't want it to be streamed, but okay, first of all, let's check this out, man. You cost time, Tim. Super chats, then Mathis. You never had a problem with Tim on the OC. Let's go here. Let's go here. Whoa. Hello? 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 Hi?
No, nobody
did it. Oh. Hello? Uh-oh. It's a lot of people. Yeah. No. Oh, it's a spill. Oh. Careful. Oh, damn. They got the bar. Okay. That's good. Okay. Check this out. Stuff. Let's go say hello to Markus. Then we can grab a drink. Hey, Ryan. Come. Say hello to Markus. Let's go say hello. Hey, I'm live streaming. Is it okay?
Yeah, you're good.
Dude, I figured, you know what? This is going to be a really cool event. Let me live stream. I got 100 people watching.
Jesus Christ.
You know what? Watch community.
Hi, everybody.
Coming
Thank
in.
Thank you for the support.
Yeah, there you go.
It's not watcher. We do have watchers here, though.
Yeah. There are Leica watches, guys. Ever? Look at this.
Yeah, yeah.
We're going to show some watches. Yeah. Thank you. Oh, no. We'll do later. Yeah. Okay. He wants to show. Very cool. Okay. We're going to get a one-on-one tour from Markus. Okay. Let's look around what's happening here. We'll get back to this. Markus got a little bit of time. Oh, yeah. Here. Check. This is the one I got. Got this one.
Amazing.
Yeah.
Photo.
Road to Kilimanjaro.
Look at this.
Bonkers, right? Look
exactly.
At the sky.
Look at the sky.
Holy crap.
Look at the dark. It's just.
Yeah, and then you can see all the people carrying all the weight.
All the detail here.
Yeah. This is like.
This is a good one.
Watch community. This is to me. I got this one.
This is a good one.
This one is really cool too.
To the mountain, to the peak.
He's gonna tell us the story behind each one of these pictures later, so this is gonna be very cool. This one, walking. This one's colorful. Look at that.
You know, he actually worked out a lot to be able to accomplish this trip.
Oh yeah.
He told me he worked out every day. He's running. He's a good jogger, running. Uh-huh. 10 miles, 20 miles a day or something.
Yeah.
Because you have to build out your body.
Yeah.
This is not an easy mountain. Oh. And especially
some people don't make it.
No.
Right.
And
yeah.
Yeah, you can tell he's pretty fit.
Oh,
he's
yeah.
Pretty,
no,
yeah.
He is fit.
Yeah, he's
good. So he's a big guy. He's really tall built. He's he's jacked almost, you know? Let's get a drink. While we're waiting to have a chat with him, we'll give him to spend some time with everybody else, and then we'll get him at the end. Yeah. Hi. Hello. 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 Hi. Hey. I'm live.
Yes, you did. When the earthquake happened.
Oh, you were here for the earthquake.
You want to be on camera? Is it okay?
Whatever.
Okay.
We had another earthquake just a few minutes ago.
Oh,
really?
Man.
Can you tell?
You didn't notice this?
No, we didn't. We were sitting outside.
I guess you're not a very sensitive person.
No, I'm not. I am very sensitive, actually. But we were sitting outside, and we had a couple of drinks already.
Hello, would you like a rosé?
Yes. Thank you.
But, rosé. Oh, rosé.
Rosé.
Shout out to rosé.
Shout out to rosé, Paul. Let's go.
What are these cameras? Yeah, is this we can take one? A disposable camera?
I don't know. Actually.
What are these?
Here when I sat down.
They're here to cake. Talk to Markus. Okay, yeah, yeah. I'm sure he'll. I'll save it for other people. I have the digital one.
Thank you.
Sir, I was telling.
We're also encouraging people to add a splash of rum.
Oh, splash of rum. Add a splash. Add a splash of rum in the rosé. Can I get with a splash of rum? Sir, what's your name? Ryan's getting a little bit of rosé. Sir, what's your name?
Renee.
And
Renee.
We encourage people.
Rum, a little bit of rum in there. No, Ryan doesn't want rum. Okay. Renee, they don't believe me that when I was buying Markus's print, that's when the earthquake happened.
You're the one that didn't pay for it.
Oh, no, I have the money. Look, look, I have the money.
Ah, look at that.
I brought the money to pay for it. You see it?
Yeah.
I know what's up. I'm going to pay
for it. What about it?
No, I was just saying that I bought the print. When I was buying the print, that's when the earthquake happened.
Well, you see,
yeah,
you spent
right?
money and the earth moved.
Exactly. You can move earth with $100. It's incredible.
Well, it's 75.
Right? 75 plus taxes. Plus tip. All right, so it is. Oh, can I get one with a rum?
I don't know. Can we trust you?
Yeah, of course. Why not? What? What the? Come on. Okay, without rum, okay? I'll take it.
My name's Sean. Yeah. It's here to do buy some accessory for him, right?
Oh, what was it?
I forgot. I told you, right?
Text him. Get in touch with him. Yeah, Sean said I need to buy some kind of an accessory from Leica, so we'll find out what it is. Thank you so much. You did? Oh, thank you. Cheers, Renee. You're a legend. And if anybody wants to come here to buy a Leica, ask for Renee, correct? Yeah.
We don't work on commission, but...
No commission. Exactly. Okay, yeah.
We work on omission.
Omission, okay. Thank you.
Our permission.
Permission.
With love.
Oh. Mm. Oh, yeah, yeah. He's got a watch there. Are you wearing a watch?
No, I'm not a watch guy.
Oh, you're not a watch guy. Okay, okay. All right, cool. What's your name? Zayan? Zayan. Oh, okay. Okay. You were like a photographer or?
I work here.
Oh, you work here. Okay, right. I think I saw you earlier. Yeah. 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 Cool. Tim Wright. I was here when the earthquake happened.
Yeah. The first earthquake.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And then he said, there's no trains here. I'm like, what the hell? What does that mean? Yeah. Here, check it out. That's my channel. If you're ever interested in watches, yeah. Here's one for you, Renee. Thank you.
A wise man told me I only have one expensive hobby.
Yeah. Oh yeah, the camera. Oh, these are good cameras.
It's
a Q3, right? Is that a Q3? Oh, can we compare it to Q2? He's got a Q2. Let's just. Yeah.
They look the same.
They do. They really.
This one has.
Oh, Science. Look at that.
The glove has the effect.
Yeah. Okay. So this
if
is
if you don't
difference.
Do an inspection, you wouldn't be able to tell the difference.
Wow.
Same lens.
I love
this camera.
Yeah.
Do the flippy screen one more time for us. Wow. So you can tilt it up or you can tilt it down.
You can tilt it down.
Interesting.
It doesn't
right?
flip out.
When did you get that? It's pretty hard to get.
No, this is the storage screen, too. So.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah.
Oh, there's a spill? Okay. There. Are there... Oh, so same lens.
This one doesn't have the tilt.
Yeah, as you can see, there's no tilt. But it's like, is it really worth that much more? I mean, it depends. You know, he got
this
that for 2000. He got it for 2000. The maniac.
Oh, that's a
yeah.
Steel.
Yeah,
steel.
Yeah, steel.
You don't even get it for 2000.
Yeah. Fucking legend. He takes pictures of wristwatches. He's on the Instagram. You have to check out his Instagram. He is insane.
See, I'm not even a watch guy. That watch.
You like that?
I like it.
For sure.
Hell yeah, that's
what's
a
type
Rolex.
Of Rolex. It's a Rolex. Tell. It's a Rolex. It's a Daytona.
Daytona. Okay.
But it's the older version.
Okay.
Just come out with a new version last year.
Okay.
But I still like this one. I got this like 5 years ago.
Yeah, so is the DNS new version, is this one become less wanted?
No,
it's
good.
It's
still pretty nice. It's just like still over retail.
Yeah.
Yeah, crazy.
Highly demand. Yeah. You have to buy like many, many watches today to be able to get access to that one. People pay twice on the like. On eBay, the price that they cost at the store.
Oh, damn.
And Rolex had previews earlier today. So we did a live show kind of analyzing all the new watches that may be coming out.
Yeah?
Yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah. This is what we do. We live stream and we talk about wristwatches.
Yeah, this on YouTube?
Yeah, on YouTube. Live streams, yeah. Check it out. Check it out. He, by the way, I want, like, he's really shy. But if you check his Instagram, SmallG, check his Instagram.
I don't have my phone.
Oh, you don't have your phone. Okay, okay. But like, his, I don't have my phone. Show your Instagram. He's like, he takes pictures with that Leica of different wristwatches, and he's really good. And I was thinking like, man, it would be cool to have a watch meetup of like, to show.
Yeah, yeah, this is amazing.
Right? And it,
so are these all people you know or people you
know? No, these are his. These are all his. He's a maniac, yeah. Well, he's like, he's like a, dude, he's like, he's the one who helped design COVID vaccine. Yeah.
I believe it.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. How can he get a, like, print here and do an exhibition? That would be so fucking cool, I think.
It's not my call.
Yeah.
We'd have to speak with Renee. He's
yeah,
one
yeah.
curates the gallery.
I mean, take a look at his Instagram. You know, you got my card. Send me a text. I'll connect. I'll show you his Instagram.
Yeah, yeah.
Maybe there's something
yeah,
that we could do.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because.
Likewise.
What's your name?
I work here at the store. So. I'm Zaire. Zaire.
Zaire, nice to meet you.
Likewise.
Yeah.
Dude,
you want
like
a fan this man.
Come to the store.
Come to the store.
Like a Soho.
A lot of like watch enthusiasts, they like buying their things. And cameras like Leica, these are the top of the top.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely.
I want to inspire more passion in photography for my viewers.
Leica is a lifestyle.
Yeah.
It's a lifestyle. It's a lifestyle you have to have with like high-end luxury stuff. It's kind of
yeah.
And also take a good picture for sure.
These are amazing watches. You can't take a picture with your phone.
No,
right? You gotta step it up.
Leica is the Rolls Royce on a Rolex.
Yes.
Of cameras.
That's it.
Yeah, so.
Dude, thank you so much for
explaining
it to my viewers.
Yeah.
Nice to meet you, man.
Likewise. Thank you, guys. I appreciate it.
Thank you.
I'm going to have some more.
Yeah, exactly. And if you take some pictures of me, you know, I would, if you could send them to me,
yeah,
it would
absolutely.
Be really cool. I'm trying
to
promote the brand.
I'm not on photo duty. I'm more so on
TV. Oh, okay,
event.
Okay.
But
okay.
Marcus has some photos that he wanted me to get for.
Oh, yeah. Is this his camera?
No,
oh, no,
this
your
is
camera.
The store's camera.
Gotcha, okay.
I have an SL sweat.
Cool. Hey, SmallG, take pictures with your Leica in the store, like, you know, of, like, the things happening, okay? Sorry. Okay, let's see it. All right, let's go. Where do we go this way? Shout out Tim Networking, Marco. Yo, Marco in the house. Thank you for the upvote. Ask if he heard a 4B. Can you pick me up a cap that won't fall off? Maybe they make a new cap for the Q2. Are you serious, Negroni? If you're serious, let me know. Timmy offers the guy to be a model. Okay.
I like Westwood. I love Westwood.
Please? Oh, maybe I'll go through. Hey, by the way, also, guys.
Hello, how are you?
These are some Leica watches here. Check it out, team. You guys thought this was just an event for cameras? No, this is a wristwatch event. So, upper. It's a wristwatch, Leica wristwatch event. Yeah, ask them if they made a new one. Oh, okay. Do they really fall off? For Q2? Oh, yeah, yeah. Tim, show us some Leica cameras. Oh, okay. Oh, there we go. That's it. Take pictures, take pictures. Take pictures of wristwatches all people have. Let me show you guys some Leica cameras. Maybe we can get somebody to present them to us. Yeah, it's like an entire history. This is a museum. They got all the... Oh, guys, I'll show you everything. It's a museum here. Oh, but I need somebody who knows this stuff to explain it to us.
You could easily spend $1 million.
Oh, yeah. No question that. These are like the SLRs with interchangeable lenses. You got the OGs over there. Probably back from the back of time to the most modern one. Right here. It's Markus and his date. Very cool. And it looks like they have these all over the place. I'm not sure what this is all about. And this is, I think, what's available for sale. Oh, yeah. This is for sale right here. Okay. This is what we got. This is the Leica Q3. This is what I recommend. Look, well, maybe I would recommend the Q2 if you can get it for cheap. But the Q3, if there's like watch enthusiasts and they want the easy to use Leica, this is the one I would recommend. I wouldn't go with a really hardcore one. This is a point shoot. This is what Sean from LA got. So the Q. And then there's a blacked out version. You see how I think these are both Q3. One has the red dot Leica, and then the other one doesn't have a red dot. It's just black. Because there's some people who like to flex, and then this is how you get it. And if you don't, if you want to be super stealth, you can get it like this. Like a wedding, Tim, you're supposed to snap candid shots with the disposable. Gotcha. Here we go. Let's see here. We got some more of these. These are with the interchangeable. Not a huge fan of the interchangeable ones. I do like the M series. Where's the M? Is it this? This is like a cool one. It's like a Polaroid. Look at that. Basically, you get a pack of prints. You load it up into the camera, and then you can take pictures like that. It's kind of charming. Hey, yo, Eddie, move the fucking mouth, you man. Thank you.
What you drinking?
Rosé. Dude, oh, like over there, God. With a splash of rum. Go get it. I'll tell you some stuff about this thing. Go grab a drink. Eddie Mao, guys, in the house. Eddie. He made it. Rosé. Rosé Paul. For now. He's gonna skip for now. Oh, wait. Oh, yeah, never. Please. Oh. No, we cannot. Fries with me, they're saying rosé. Like Rosé Pong. One of the OGs. One of the true OGs. Right, let's sit here. Let me. Look at all the cameras behind me. Pretty cool. I wish I could. Is that fine? Okay, I just want to leave the jacket. I'm hot. There's nothing in the pocket, so. Thank you. Yeah. It's a little bit hot, guys. All right, let's see what's going on in the chat. Leica camera community looks like a bigger bunch of dweebs than the watch community. Okay, I don't know. We'll find out. Are they dweebs? I don't know. They like photographs. How about we start the tour on looking at the photographs? How about that? Let me guys give you the preview. These are the most important photographs here. This is where the event starts, okay? So let's just enjoy this, okay? Actually, let's read this. Kilimanjaro, me and my grandfather's Leica, Markus et al. And then we got artist statement. From an early life spent behind the lens to years of professional documentary and commercial directing, it was the recent shift to film photography that inspired me to explore the evolution of my life through a stills lens in this book. Project Me and My Grandfather's Leica. What better tool for this journey than my grandfather's Leica M6, discovered in a locked safe within my brother's cluttered storage closet. Growing up, altitude was my adversity. Ski trips were marred by altitude sickness, setting me apart from my siblings. Oh, he's got siblings. Very interesting. I do want to know a little bit more about his family. Markus is an interesting character in this situation. Seeking a challenge that would not only start a narrative of this book, but also conclude my year on a high note. I turned to the mountains. Mount Kilimanjaro just felt right. A mountain I always dreamed of climbing. The tallest mountain in Africa. The tallest freestanding mountain in the world. So off I went. The biggest challenge in life is the Mount Kilimanjaro. This here, let's see it. What is this? This looks like possibly the peak. It says here, fog over the lava tower. The max. So I guess this is the maximum altitude. Wow. This is the top, I guess. The top of the mountain right there. Very cool. As you can see, if I come closer, you'll be able to see there's the camp that was set up. On top of this mountain of what, I don't know. I think this might be the peak. We'll talk to Markus to find out what this is actually. So make sure you stay put. And then here, we got this picture. These are the two most important pictures of this presentation. So it's important to understand these. It says headlamps in the final hour. So the altitude is 19,100 feet. So I'm guessing this is just before 1 mile away from the peak. I might be getting it wrong, but as we walk in, we got the instruments. These are the instruments of choice. Sorry guys, I'm doing a live stream. It's okay, you can be closer in. It's okay, I'm not getting you in the shot. We're looking here at, this is actual, his grandfather's pictures. So as you can see, his grandfather has been taking very similar pictures and creating a photo book like that. And he kept very meticulous records of all the negatives. That's the camera that he used to take pictures, or to take all of these pictures. Here he's got some negatives, and you can see there's a notebook that he kept journal in. The titles in these say My Grandfather's M6, My Grandfather's Photo Album, and these are his nuggets. He's got a shoot book and lens. Oh, this is the lens that he was using, I'm guessing. Very interesting stuff. Guys, upload the live stream if you're enjoying this show so far. Let's get a refill. Wow. Wow, it's getting crazy in here. Wow. Markus is getting swarmed. Unbelievable. Let's go see what the boys are thinking. We'll get back to Markus. And momentarily.
Excuse me.
Let's see. Where are everybody? Hey, hey. There's our crew. Hello, everybody. Is it watch guy? Hello, sir. Nice to meet you. Oh, you're wearing a watch? Let's see. Oh, wait. Is that the new one or is that the old one? That's the old one. Same one. Very nice. Hey, check this out. There we go. Yeah. It's a Moritz Grossmann. What is that shader? It's a German independent.
Is it hammer?
Hammer
dial?
Yeah, that's tremblage.
Really nice.
Just like the earthquake earlier today.
Yeah.
Tremble, tremblage. I thought it was a perfect watch to wear to the event.
It is perfect.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Yeah. By the way, I'll give you my my card. You want to be on camera or you don't want to be on camera? You don't mind? Okay, so hey, hello. What's your name?
Hi, my name's Eric.
Eric, do you have Instagram where people can follow your wristwatches, or you don't have Instagram for wristwatches?
I have an Instagram. It's NYC _ engineer.
NYC engineer.
Yeah.
Ah, shoot me a text message. I would love to have you like on the show to talk about your wristwatch collecting journey. Dude, that would be incredible because we're a watch community. We love wristwatches. You know, Markus over there, he's an incredible watch collector. He's trying to... Today, this is like, you know, his photography thing, his passion, his grandfather's. But he has another passion where he makes films about watch collectors.
I've been to the screening.
Oh, so that's why you're here.
Yeah,
I get it. Okay, very cool. Wait, what's your name again?
Eric.
Like Eric Wynn. Okay, I'll try to remember. So, what is this? This is Panda Daytona. How did you get this one? You want to tell us a little bit like about your watch collecting passion? How did you get this watch?
Sure. I started shopping for watches in 2020 when we had to wear masks at the store. And then eventually over a couple of years, I bought more Rolexes than is reasonable and then got offered this one.
It's a mistake we all made.
Yeah.
You know?
But I got it at retail price, so I'm very happy about
it. It's no big deal. Yeah, perfect. I like that. So, have you ventured outside of Rolex, or is that something you're still skeptical of or waiting to do?
Definitely have a couple of Grand Seiko.
Your Grand Seikos, okay. Yeah.
Tudor, I love.
Tudor.
And a couple of the small ones, of course.
Okay.
But largely Rolex for now.
Rolex for now. Look, we are a watch community that explores all types of watches. All right, we love everything from Rolex to Patek to Richard Mille to watches that our wristwatch YouTuber friends make for us. Here, look, I'm wearing a Ming over here. There's another watch.
Really nice.
Heard of this brand?
I have,
yeah. So this is a Ming. I think it won like a GPSG award. But this was my Canadian friend's watch, and he wanted to sell it, and I thought, oh my God, I'll take it. It's incredible because it's my friend's watch.
Yeah.
Right. It's a Ming. It is a little bit special. You know, it's a stamp dial, right?
Salmon dial.
Salmon stamp.
Uh-huh.
Right. And it was like it retailed for $2,000. It's back when it was actually one of the first watches that I discussed on my live stream. And I didn't know about this brand until I started doing my show here. And people taught me about the whole GPSG bullshit, and then I got indoctrinated. But it is a charming watch here. But, you know, we've got an incredible community here. This is Eddie, Ryan, SmallG. SmallG has a really cool photography Instagram account. He takes incredible watch pictures. I was telling him, like, this guy, he should have a wristwatch exhibition here.
Yeah, he could be selling the photos.
Yeah, he could be selling a little bit of photos. You know, he's passionate about watches. He's the guy who helped make the COVID-19 vaccine.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah, right? And he's a watch guy. No one, I mean, look, that's why he's got...
Wow.
Yeah, you know, you do such a thing, it does help out. What do you do for a living? I mean, if you want to share like a little bit about your personal life, like why do you get watched? What made you from your real life become a watch enthusiast?
Oh, Well, it's a good question. I think I share the reason with a lot of people, which is my dad or my uncle. You know, I think they got me into it.
Yeah.
But they never would buy themselves really nice watches.
Yeah.
So now I buy nice watches and we like rotate with them so they get to wear it. But for my day job, I'm a software engineer.
Okay, very nice.
So for me,
these are well-paying jobs. Yeah.
For me, like watches, you know, they're beautiful. They're well-made. They're precise. So for me, that's like a reminder that my work should also be like well-made and done beautifully. So it's like a little reminder to do things well.
Yeah, I like that. I really like that. You know, it's like a reminder. You look at it and you say, you know what? Rolex has put in so much work, so much effort, such you know, extraordinary amount of love to make these products. You know, the way they did it, in the way they did it,
yeah.
That it inspires you to do better yourself. Exactly. And you want to live up to what Rolex represents. I totally get it. Yeah. You know, I do have a couple of Rolexes as well. And, you know, the reason I like Rolexes is also kind of like because you technically you could have one for the rest of your life,
yes.
Right? And it will fulfill its job, it will last, and it's like everything else in life is disposable, right? These phones, computers. Dude, I got a fucking scale, you know, the bathroom scale that attaches to your app, like it's got an app thing, right? And it fucking broke! Oh, I almost went ballistic, man. I almost threw it out the window, okay? Because they updated the app, and I think the software no longer syncs. And it's fucked.
Yeah.
So the technology...
It's being lazy. They planned it that way.
Yeah, it's really unfortunate that they did it. You guys, as software engineers, you have to build in guardrails to make sure that the stuff you build could then be reprogrammed by the next generation,
yeah.
If that makes sense.
Yeah, definitely.
Right? But sometimes, you know, it is what it is, man. You know, you just gotta do what you gotta do, right?
Yeah.
So, I mean, look, let's see if the watch nerds got any questions for you. Tim loves the wild beards. Sorry about my look, man. I'm doing this whole thing, escaping from the Shutter Island.
You know how,
yeah, it's why I haven't shaved in like a month and a half. I'm a YouTuber, I don't give a fuck. Wait, hold on a second. This looks awful.
Do people tell you you're more intimidating?
I'm trying to look a little bit more intimidating because I'm like a really nice guy. I like to hang out with people. But there's this one motherfucker that really pissed me off. So I'm just trying to send a message.
It
definitely does
that.
Yeah, I hope that it does. Yeah. JMB, Tim is the real hipster. Okay. Such a nice content photography. Well done. By the way, are you a photographer? Tell us about your passion of photography.
It's a small hobby for me. You know, I'll keep this on the show.
Oh, what is this?
It's the closest thing I had to a Leica for this Leica store event.
Yeah.
It's another German camera, but it's just you know, fun. I shoot film with it.
You shoot film?
Yeah.
How do you know Markus?
I know him. We're both in a group, you know, for fans of watches.
Ah,
and then
we
met through a couple of events, so now we know each other.
Interesting. You came out to support a fellow watch enthusiast doing photography. Have you, do you do any, you know, do you post your photography? Do you share your passion or do you just keep it for yourself?
Keep it for myself as well.
That's fine. Listen, that's fine. You don't have to be public with everything you do in life, right?
Yeah.
You know, it's just how it is. You have an Instagram account that people can follow you on?
Just that watch Instagram account.
Just that watch.
Yeah.
Just that
watch. No. Just the other Instagram account.
What's the other one?
The NYC Engineer.
NYC Engineer. Guys, if one of the wrenches can... there's not a lot of wrenches left. If one of the wrenches can drop the link to...
NYC Engineer.
NYC Engineer. Sorry, I can't recall on the fly. You know, my memory is not that great, man. I wish it was, but I'm trying... NYC Engineer, right?
Yeah.
NYC Engineer, NYC Engineer, NYC Engineer. JMB says Tim also use film real hit. Okay, they're just making fun of me here. I get it. Is that a Leica in your pocket or are you just pass it to see me? Are you happy to see me?
Look, I am happy to see everybody here. It's pretty cool. Have you considered buying one of the prints?
They're surprisingly reasonably priced.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I actually, earlier in the day, when I was, so I came to talk to Markus here about some wristwatch stuff, bullshit, in the morning, right? And we were having breakfast across the street. Uh-huh. And then we come over here, he showed me some stuff, it was very cool. And then I was looking at the prints. I actually bought one of those, but like, when I considered buying it, that's when the earthquake happened. Uh-huh. Yeah, and like, because the guy at the, you know, the Richie guy, he's like, there's no subway here. And I'm like, what the fuck is he talking about? There's no subway. Oh, that no. Means this is happening for real.
Yeah.
And so it was like when I made the decision to buy. And so then I was like, oh man, this is a sign. This guy is going to shake up the world. We might be here at the, you know, when it's like the beginning. When it's just starting out.
Right.
So, I mean, those prints might be really valuable. So I'm glad that I bought one, okay?
It was a sign.
You have to, yeah, it was a sign.
Yeah.
Shaking up the world. And the print I was looking at Mount Kilimanjaro. The biggest earthquake probably that ever happened on the planet to make that mountain in the first place. Yeah, okay. Listen, I don't want to take up too much of your time, but you've been fucking cool. You wanna tell us something. Final words. Oh, sir.
No. Thanks for having me on your channel.
Can we have you on the stream to tell your full wristwatch journey?
I'll message you.
Did I give you a card?
Yeah.
Okay, good. What's your name again?
Eric.
Eric, man. Thanks. Fucking legend. Thank you so much, man. Tim Wright.
Okay.
Okay.
Nice to meet you.
Hey, Markus. You wanna say hi? Come say hi.
Hello, stream. How many people do we have? Oh, we lost people. Oh no.
No, 84 people.
But we had 100 earlier.
Oh look, it comes in and out. It's okay.
Okay. Should we calm down?
Ooh, speech! Speech.
I don't know how to do this.
Speech!
Can we turn the music off too?
Oh wow. Oh, that worked.
Wow. See?
Oh my gosh.
The power.
We're on the spot. All right. Hello, everyone. It is very exciting to be here. Thank you, everyone, for showing up. This is the first show from the Leica store Soho since COVID. So thank you guys so much for hosting me. We'll clap for that.
Thank you.
Woo! Incredibly, incredibly exciting to see the community and everybody and all my friends come into one room and see something that isn't watches, right?
Yes!
For those of you that don't know, I'm a commercial director and I work in the watch industry primarily. I make videos and commercials for watch companies, and then as if that's not enough of my life, I also have a large personal project called Stories of Collectors that is all of my other side of my creative life, which is a film series about watch collectors. So this is the first time we're doing something creatively not watch related, and the fact that we have people here is really exciting. So thank you so much for being here. I have a little presentation. We'll keep it nice and short. I had a much longer one, but we condensed it, so that's good. Basically, this is chapter one of a book called Me and My Grandfather's Leica. As it implies, it's 1 year of shooting on the camera that my grandfather had at the end of his life. He did have a Leica M3, sort of in the middle of his life, that he shot with the most, and he ended up selling it and trading it in for a Leica M6 towards the end of his life. And unfortunately, he was an accountant, so we know this for sure. He had all of his, and you can see at the exhibit up front, like, he has had every single one of his negatives, like, obsessively cataloged. So we know for sure that there was only about 6 rolls that went through the camera. So I am writing the first chapter of this camera's story and its life, and it started in the mountains in Tanzania, climbing a mountain. So yeah, that is this. We will start, I guess. Oh, and
whoa.
Thank you also to Wolfer State Vineyards. They supplied the wine. Drink it, the rosé, it's really, really beautiful. The bottles are really, really beautiful. You have to say it, I'm very excited. And honestly, we could have had anyone, we could have also just paid, I could have had Leica just pay for wine. Like, there was only one liquor sponsor that we ever even considered, and that was always one.
That rosé is amazing.
Yeah, you know.
I'm gonna have 3 more glasses, so just, don't take it easy over there, guys, okay? I want something to be left for me.
All right, so this is one of my favorite photos from the show. I'm under NDA about where it's going, but this is going somewhere very special in the medium-term future, between 6 and 8 months.
Whoa.
Say anything else, but this is going somewhere. Where did this all start? I mean, my history teacher, Dr. DeGraff, is somewhere here. He would know that on school trips, at school, everywhere, I was always taking photographs and always just enjoying just telling stories, or attempting to tell stories at least. And after years of shooting professionally, shooting in college, shooting for work, a little dude named Wen, who's right over there, say hi, he walked up to me, and walked up is a strong term. He actually flew literally around the entire world. He lives in Singapore and now he moved to New York. And he put a camera in my hand and he said, "You need to learn how to shoot on a Leica M series camera." That was them too. That was about, 3 years now? Time is flying. And I picked it up, and whether I liked it or not, I was shooting film. And that began an amazing journey that has primarily been a hobby up until now, and is a hobby that I'm sure many of you enjoy now, which is awesome. It wasn't until about a year ago that I found out that there was a historical piece in the family, my grandfather's M6. And I picked it up and I said, we need to do something amazing with this. And that something is this long-term project. We're currently writing it, so I don't know what all the chapters are, but chapter one is certainly climbing a mountain. So that's me and my Leica, my grandfather's Leica. That's actually on the mountain. There's a different version of the photo over there. Who is my grandfather? He lived in Innsbruck, Austria, which is where my father's from. He was not a photographer at all, but he was a very passionate amateur. We recorded roughly 100 rolls through his Leica M3 and 6 rolls through his Leica M6. It's been amazing just going through all of this stuff. And more than anything, what we see is he had a true passion for photography, a true passion for quality. And as I continue to investigate and ask my dad and my uncle and the rest of my family over and over, he had a passion for Leica. And that's something that I think everyone here has. It's very exciting. So, how did we choose Kilimanjaro in this chapter? When I was younger, we would go on ski trips all the time. I was very lucky in that sense. And on those skiing trips, as my mom will painfully remember, we would sometimes go up on the mountain and I would just collapse and end up being brought down by ski patrol or by her carrying me down. I never did well with altitude. It was always something where my siblings were having a blast and having the time of their lives on these vacations, and I would be back at home either literally on an oxygen system or just sitting there passed out dying. So naturally, I was like, let's climb a really high mountain. That seems like a good idea.
Hell yeah.
Seriously, as a lot of you guys know, and if you don't know, last year was an amazing year. We did a lot of collector series stuff. We did a lot of professional work, and it just felt like a year to take on a challenge at the end of the time. And I couldn't think of any other challenge than overcoming altitude and climbing a mountain, and that's what we did.
Hell yeah.
This is the kit for all the nerds out there, and I know there's a few of us. I touched the projectors. We had my grandfather's Leica M6. We had an M10D with only 4 batteries. Uh-oh. When you're on a mountain for 10 days, you really can't charge battery. That doesn't really work, so that's a sticking point for sure. Flash, 40 rolls of film. Renee told me to bring more. I walked in here 2 weeks before. I was like, should I bring 10 or 20? Renee was like, no. 40. Thank you very much. That was very expensive. We ended up bringing a 24mm, 40mm, and a 75 Somalex, which was probably the most used lens across all of these photographs. And naturally, it was the Leica lens that we used, so it makes sense.
Wow.
The plan was to fly to Africa, yeah. Find a mountain, try to climb it. Pretty simple to me. This is the team that got me there. I was just as much of a tourist as anyone else. Anyone in this room, I truly believe, can do it. It was not that difficult, but it takes an immense amount of mental persistence and a little bit of training. On the left, we had Dismas, who's the assistant guide, and on the right is Imani, whose quote at the very front of the show is right there. He's never been more than 100 miles away from his village in Kilimanjaro. He's never been on an airplane, never been on a helicopter, never been on anything other than a car and a bus. And he said, and I'm paraphrasing, but you can read the exact quote, "The world is like a book, and here in Tanzania and myself, we are just at the cover." And I thought that was a really special line because it really resonated with me. You know, I just flew around the whole world, and you know, on the way back, I'd go via Dubai all the way to Los Angeles. Like, it was not an easy way to get there, but he's never been more than 100 miles away. That's kind of crazy. So I did the Limosha route. We'll do a really brief way through. Day one is getting to the mountain. Day two is your first climb, sort of emerging out of the jungles. Day three is where this beautiful photograph that is the front photograph that I can't talk about was taken. Day four is pretty much the hardest day for me, and that's where the lava tower comes from. Before the trip, I knew that there was, you know, it was going to be a photo trip. I was wondering, what is the best way that we could sort of highlight this? Like, if there's one photograph that I want to take, aside from the summit, what is it? And everything just seemed like landscapes. I'm not a landscape photographer. That's not what I enjoy. It's fun, but it's not like my primary domain. I wanted to tell a story. And the only thing that I could think of was the lava tower and the... Actually, where is it? We'll jump over there. This is me when we got up there with the team, and keep on doing that. That's the photo on the right. And basically, the lava tower is interesting because it's an acclimatization thing. You don't need to go there. You really shouldn't have to go there if you're going up. It's, you go there just to go up, have lunch, spend 2 hours, let your body revise and feel healthy, and then you go back down. Then 2 days later, you go back up to the altitude and you should feel better. I didn't process that. So when I got there, that's what I looked like. Yeah. Not the
Jeez.
That is me eating a piece of chicken, just staring at my plate, and the team knows, my team knows, my friends know, this is one of four photos, and they are all the exact same thing. This is not like we picked one moment to look stupid. This is literally how we looked. I was exhausted.
Wow.
And for that to end up with this photograph, basically we waited about an hour and a half and rested, had lunch, and relaxed, and it wasn't until we were literally told we have to leave with a rescue helicopter taking another tourist down that I was like, all right, I knew that I wanted this photograph. Let's just take it. So I picked up the camera, we pointed at it, and I really only took four photos, so I'm really happy that my skills resonated and we were able to land a shot, and that's the one that's out front on the right. Other complications? Flash. I don't really do flash. I work in cinema and film. We just have DPs and gaffers, and you just sort of tell them what to do with lighting, and they do it. It's a really, really, really nice thing to have, and it's one of the best things to have as a director, but I didn't have any of that. This is just me and my grandfather's Leica, so that was the contact sheet for summit night, which starts at midnight, and you climb all the way until about 8 a.m., and really only... three photos are really visible, but it was certainly a shot in the dark, literally. I did plan that, and you know, it is what it is. The photo furthest to the left, slide number six, should be somewhere in that pile. There's only one of them, but yeah, that was it. Some other shots from there. You know, it's when you miss your shot, that's sort of the nature of it. Nothing ever works out perfectly, and this is a great reminder of that. Summit day is a lot more than people expect, and it's certainly more than I expect. In general, summit day you call the day that you go up to the top. Day seven, you're up there at 7 a.m., that's what it is. For me, I do not agree with that, and my team did not agree with that, the guides did not agree with that. Summit day starts 36 hours before at the Barranco camp. That's the last full night of sleep that you have. You start there and you hike about 15 hours all the way to base camp. At base camp, you arrive there at like noonish, 1 o'clock. You have a quick lunch and you're told to sleep. Nobody can sleep at 1 o'clock. I certainly can't sleep at 1 o'clock, even after all the messiness. So that's me taking photos. My guide literally looked at me and was like, why are you awake? Because nobody can sleep at 2 o'clock when it's bright and sunny and the adrenaline's running through your body. But that is at Kosovo camp, 13 hours before summit. And basically, you try to sleep, and about 11:30, you have dinner, and then you start on your climb. After resting, breakfast is right there. That was taken on my iPhone, actually, which is a reoccurring thing in some of these photographs. That is a friend of mine, Mike, who is prepping right before we leave. Long hike, about 4 hours before we summited. That's just from Kosovo up to Stella Point. At Stella Point, my guides were really, really amazing. They had hot tea for us. There was one guide that literally came up just for the hot tea. That was amazing. We were the only tourists to have that, so special. Felt really amazing. That's at 18,885 feet, the highest this camera has ever been, the highest I've ever been outside of an airplane. It was really, really tough, but amazing. Just after that, you have about half an hour before summit, we have the sunrise and the final steps, which is the photo that we have the most of for sale. And then we make it to the top at 19,300 feet.
Wow. Incredible.
It was really anticlimactic, honestly. I ran around, I took a few photos. Frankly, and that's why it's up there, that's why it's amazing, what's special to me, the Lava Tower day was the hardest day by far. This just felt natural after we were prepared, so.
Can I ask a question?
In a bit.
Yeah.
In a bit.
Yeah.
That's the part that they don't tell you. So you, I said it was anticlimactic. I was like, cool, we're taking photos, we're having fun, the team is there, I'm there, it's great. And then you have to go down. Nobody tells you that. I'm just like, all right, cool. Do we have more tea? Like, can we have like the kitchen do something? No, that's not how this works. So, long hike down, a really long hike down. And this photo was taken literally 6 hours after the summit in the rain. We were not even close to the bottom yet. They really don't tell you that. But it was funny because these two photos are shot on film. This one's digital on my iPhone. The contact sheet for the summit day literally ends about an hour after the summit. I was so exhausted on the way down. We put the camera away and just were stepping one step at a time, just praying we could get back down. And it wasn't until about 28 hours after the summit that you were down on the ground, safe and sound, and you can finally take a shower after 8 hours.
Jeez.
That's me. Final photo is being added to my logbook. My logbook is at the front on view. Photo of me finally at the gate, taking a selfie to send to my lovely girlfriend in the back. That was the first communication she got after 9 days of being on the mountain. On the way to the airport. And then finally, this was my journey back to the United States. The second I landed, I immediately went to In-N-Out Burger in Los Angeles. It was so amazing. And that was the journey. And that should be the end, but it's not. This is the end of chapter one. So I don't really know what's happening next. I have a lot of ideas, and we're writing the chapters as we go. But it's on to the next adventure, and I'm really looking forward to finding out where we go. So that's chapter one of me and my Leica, and my grandfather's Leica.
Wow.
Good. Thank you for the wine.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you, everyone. Appreciate it.
Questions?
Questions? Okay,
questions,
nice.
Please.
Sure.
You had a black and white photo of the summit.
Yes.
I was wondering what actual time of the day was that?
We summited at about, I believe it was 6:56 in the morning was the exact time.
Was that for the sunrise?
No, with mountaineering, you want to start at midnight. So if you ever incur bad weather, it's at night and you can go down. Versus in the middle of the day, you would be stuck. So on the way down, you want it to be as bright as possible to see what you would be dealing with.
So this is like pre-dawn.
This is around.
So you've got some light in the
half an hour after sunrise.
Right.
Wow.
Just trying to get a sense of how much you could actually see in the light.
It wasn't until this photo that really it was bright enough. You can see over there and on the right, the last steps photograph. That, you know, those are headlamps. You're hiking in the dark. Yeah. Any other photo? Any other questions?
How cold was it?
The top was really, really cold. Yes, the top is extremely cold. I mean, 19,300 feet, small airplanes cruise at that altitude. So it was about 20 below zero at the time.
Oh.
Yeah. Any other questions, concerns?
Questions.
All right. Well, thank you very much for coming. Please enjoy the alcohol. Buy a print if you would like. Buy a camera if you would like. And thank you very much to the entire Leica Soho team.
Woo! Well, it's okay.
He's my husband.
Oh, it's okay. It's so cool. Wow. Are you a Leica enthusiast yourself? Oh, he is. Oh, he just brought you along with him. Ah, I see. Is he a watch enthusiast as well, or is he just a Leica enthusiast?
Our son is a watch enthusiast.
Oh, I get it. Okay. Very nice. What do you think about the photography?
It's really good, actually.
Very good.
I love that beginning photo with the tents all glowing in their bright colors. That was beautifully done.
Mm, yeah. It's very good. And the story that he's taking these pictures with his grandfather's Leica, that's very...
Well, he's a grandfather, and he's got a Leica.
Wait, he's the grandfather? Oh, he's a grandfather with a Leica. He's an actual grandfather with a Leica. Oh, hello. Hello, nice to meet you, sir. Very nice. He's a grandfather with a Leica. Very cool. We got to get you a watch next.
No, just another lens will do.
Just another lens. Ah, oh, you see, he doesn't want watches. He wants more Leica lenses. Each Leica lens is like a wristwatch, like a proper wristwatch, like 8,000, yeah.
Yes, I'm not interested in one. I already have a $3,000 watch.
Oh, what watch is that? Let's see here, let's flip. You're wearing it very interestingly on the inside out.
It's my father's.
Oh, it's an IWC.
Yes.
That's really nice. And that's your father's watch? Wow, sir, I have an IWC as well. This is an incredible watch. I like how you're wearing it. Is this a gold or is it like just...
No, just
gold. Oh, just plated. But it, you know what? It does look really nice. And the way you're wearing it is very cool. You're like wearing it on the...
Yeah, because it's easier to read.
Are you a lefty or what's the situation? No, that's just how you do it. It's your way of wearing it. Respect. Now you got your way and you know what? There's other ways. There's no correct way. Yeah.
No, my granddaughters keep telling me I'm wearing it wrongly.
Yeah, well, you know what? There's no wrong way to wear or photograph. That's right. That's right. It's the way you do it. You do how you want to do.
Exactly.
Huge respect. What camera you got there? You want to tell us?
M10 Mono.
M10, very freaking cool. And what lens? Is that 50? Oh, it is a...
Lights.
Oh, man. Do you have a photography exhibition as well? Not yet. Yes? Sorry, can you say it again?
I am exhibiting at Art Expo at Pier 36.
Are you a photographer as well?
Yes, but my photography is very different.
It's very different from your husband.
Absolutely.
How is it different? He's like a street photographer.
I do layers and layers of photographs and blend them all in Photoshop.
Oh.
Yeah.
Is there, do you have like a card that I could take a look at your work maybe? I would love to give you my card if you're ever interested in wristwatches or...
Our son is interested in...
Oh, give it to your son. Okay, tell him to watch a watch show.
Well, my son introduced me to Leica.
You know what? You have to introduce him to some good watches. Some good watch people. We got the best watch people. Oh my God, thank you so much. Margaret.
This is one of my photographs.
Uh-huh.
Like each element is a photograph that I've blended into the image.
Oh, I see. You know,
no AI. I've done it all.
Wow. Thank you so much. I'll give you my card as well. And I'll
be open all weekend if you want to go to Pier 36.
I'll try to make it.
She's a marketer.
You know what? I like photography and it's very cool. Is it London? Are you guys traveling from London?
Australia.
Oh, Australia.
We've only been in New York for a couple of years.
Really? I was in Australia once.
And you didn't visit us.
And we did, maybe next time. Do you have a place where I can crash a guest room?
Absolutely.
Yes?
Do
okay.
You come?
I will.
Our youngsters have grown up and left home.
Okay.
I would be delighted to come.
If you would be delighted, I would be delighted to come.
What's your name?
My name is Tim.
Hello, Tim.
Nice to meet you, Margaret.
Tim.
Margaret, you got my number. I was to Australia once. I want to go back. It was a bad experience the first time.
But
we need to fix it. What town are you in? In Australia. Like, what's
Canberra.
The capital is
Canberra.
Canberra.
Yeah. It's in between.
It's about 300 kilometers from Sydney. Halfway between Sydney and Melbourne.
Oh, I was to Sydney, it's Melbourne, and Brisbane.
It's closer to the mountains than either.
Let's climb the mountain together, like they did here, and take pictures.
So they're only 4,500 feet.
Yeah. Oh, it's gonna be easy. We could do it together.
Yes, exactly.
Literally an afternoon stroll. Literally.
It could be an interesting photography experiment.
It is.
Right?
I'll be delighted. Okay.
I'll be delighted to come. We can make some plans. This is what I do. I like taking people on incredible journeys.
You have two spare bedrooms. Look at you guys in the other room.
Yeah. Okay. I can get the tickets if I can stay with you. I can go on a journey. Check out my channel. If you guys like it, let's do something together, okay? All right? All right, thank you so much. Thank you so much, Margaret. I'll check out your show.
Wow. My website, yeah, all the
yeah, I have it all on the card. I'm actually, you know what? Let me protect it. I'll put it into my wallet to make sure this is not lost. This is very valuable. Thank you, Margaret. Thank you so much. Hey, wow, what an incredible experience here at the photography show. Sean, how's it going so far?
Nice.
I'm gonna go use the restroom. Can you run the stream for me? How's that sound? Talk to the ladies right there. Ladies.
I don't know how to run
a stream. Okay, all
right. I don't know how to run a stream. Let's see. All right, guys.
Let's see what we have.
Yeah.
That's why I hike as well.
Yeah.
I have. Oh, hey, I'm just waiting for the restroom.
Okay.
I'm talking to the guy. He's, this is my live stream, by the way. That's, I'm a YouTuber here. I'll give you my card. Oh, hey, it's your restroom. Yes. Yo, what's up, guys? We're just talking to a guy. He's a hiker, too. What's up? What's good?
Hiker.
I'm a little bit of a hiker. I wish I was a better hiker than I am. But I'm a better drinker, rosé drinker, than a hiker. I'm pretty good at the rosé drinking. In fact, after I use the restroom, I'll have like two more glasses. It's on the house, so you gotta. It's good. It's good stuff. You gotta live a little. What is life for? To come in, support incredible friends, have good time with friends that've been supporting you for a very long time. So this is what we're doing. We're here as a watch community.
Oh yeah.
Who's
that?
Wait, that's Jay. Hey, Jay, JMB. He's actually a film photographer as well. He's been like sending me some stuff. I'll take a look at it after the stream. Thank you for sending me. He's a film photographer. Guys, film photography, it's pretty fucking cool. You know, it might be the only way to go about this thing. Make it a little bit more special. Make it more difficult on yourself. Make it into a skill, a passion. Film photography is like wearing a wristwatch that's automatic, right? Because digital photography, that's fucking quartz.
Ooh,
right?
Super chat.
Super chat from Daniel Katz. Tim Miss wearing the Ming. I love the Ming. Shout out to Daniel Katz. Meow, meow, meow. Katz in the house. We can go to Katz Deli after this, guys.
Yeah.
What if we go to a cat's effing deli for sandwiches?
Exactly. The best sandwich in the
universe. The best sandwiches.
The best.
Okay. Let's try to make it happen, guys. I'm really excited for the cat.
What is guys doing?
I think he's writing a novel. He's taking photography there. He's Jesus taking dick pics. You know, his dick
pics. You cannot occupy that. Look at how many people here.
What is he thinking? Do you need to use the restroom too?
We have to.
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Right?
Three cups of rosé.
Come on. Get out of
here.
Oh, he's out there. We were just complaining that you're taking too long.
All right, guys.
There we go.
Hi. How are you? What do you wear? What do you guys wear? The watch. Ooh, look at this. Heavy heater. I'm just running a show for Tim. Tim is a watch YouTuber. I know you are a NYC watch guy, do you? Yeah. Pretty popular in Instagram. Yeah. Cool. Yeah, the audience, they want to see what you wear. That's why
I meant live stream.
It's a live stream, yeah.
yo.
NYC watch guy.
Oh, what? NYC. Yeah. Oh, yeah, that's right, sir. We met. We're going to keep it secret. What watch are you wearing? You want to show? Let's do a... Oh, wait. Let's flip the camera. Whoa. VIP, sir. I mean, nice meeting you here. You know, huge respect. I really like your Instagram account. By the way, that April Fool's joke. Dude, you freaking got my friends. You know, I had my friends texting me, is this guy for real? I'm like, no, fuck, it's April Fool's. Don't buy this shit. You know, he's professional. So, anyways, look, it's very cool meeting you here. I'm not going to bother you too much. Nice meeting you again. Oh, by the way, I've got the Grossman.
Oh, nice.
The Moritz Grossman.
Yeah.
You know this one, the Tremblage?
Yeah. It's a good watch.
And this is the Ming. I got this one from my friend from Canada.
Nice.
What, is this your friend?
This is my buddy, yeah.
Hey, what's your name?
Dan.
Dan. Is he a watch guy too?
No,
he's not a watch guy. Like a photography guy?
Yeah.
Okay, very cool. I mean, photography is cool. I'm not gonna... Hey, enjoy your time. Markus is a great guy for putting this together. Get the print. He's selling some of those prints. Get the print, guys. Support him. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Okay. Hey, I've seen this guy before. What's up, man? How's it going? Yeah, I'm on a live stream. Is that okay? Oh, shit. He's been controversial, as always.
So controversial.
What's your name again?
Sean.
Okay, I'm gonna remember now. Sean. I've seen this guy.
I'm Alex. Hi.
Alex? Oh, Alex? Dude, I've seen him like 3 times already. I've watched this in Wonders and then at that event, remember? Blank Pond. You had the Richard Mille.
Yep.
Yeah, very cool. Nice to see it. The gummy bears, right?
Gummy bear.
The gummy bear. Sean with the gummy bear. Fuck yeah, man. Very nice. Good on you. Hey, look.
Good to see you.
Yeah, good to see you too. If anything, we'll bump into each other again. Okay, I'll let you have fun. Hey. Let's do a live stream, guys. Okay, so those are like mega VIPs. Those are like the heaviest hitting watch collectors in this space. I don't know what you guys. Yo, that was NYC motherfucking watch guy on Instagram. And then was this his buddy. He's kind of a guy, interesting guy. He's got all these heavy hitters. I don't know where he gets them from. He's just a wacko. He's pretty cool. Hey, cheers. Cheers, bro. Hey, get refilled. Take another one. Refill. All right, it was a heavy hitters, guys, okay? I was nervous. My hands were shaking, all right? Oh, there's a guy with an FP Jorn. These FP Jorn guys, they're scared for their life. That if they get identified, they're gonna get their head cut off on the street. You gotta be careful. You gotta be careful with the FP Jorn. I'm wearing Richard Mille, a humble Richard Mille. It is what it is, guys. Cheers. Hi, ma'am. Hello.
Hi.
Hello. What's your name?
Nice to meet you.
Eileen. Nice to meet you, Eileen. I'm a live streamer.
Oh, wow.
My name is Tim. You want to come on the live stream and say hello?
What are you live streaming?
Well, I'm live streaming this event. And also, I'm a friend of the guy who's throwing the event, of course.
Markus?
Yeah, yeah. Mark, shout out to Markus. He's very cool.
Yes.
You know, how are you? How do you know Markus?
I actually met him at his screening in the watch cluster.
Oh, you're a watch fan.
I am.
Are
I actually work in the jewelry and watch industry, so I was invited to that event and I met him. And I thought he was so talented and passionate that I was like, oh my gosh, I need to meet him.
Yes.
And then after I met him, I was like, he's amazing. He's super talented, super down to earth.
Yeah.
Like, just he is who he is. But like, you know, he's just all about being creative and like, I don't know. I just really like who he is, and we became friends.
Very good vibes. What kind of, tell us about your watch collecting passion. You able to share any a little bit? Maybe show us wristwatches you brought with you.
I mean, I'm not wearing like a super fancy. I'm just wearing a Cartier watch.
Oh, Cartier. We love the Cartier, actually.
You like the Cartier?
Actually, one of my biggest supporters, sponsors of the show, he's a Cartier fan. Shout out to TGO1.
Oh, okay. Shout out to
TGO1. Cartier is going up places. I don't know if you saw, there was like a advertisement right outside around the corner of Cartier Trinity.
So it's 100-year anniversary of Cartier Trinity. So I work for Van Cleef & Arpels, and we're a part of the same company. So Cartier is actually a floor below us. So they're part of our family of brands, you know.
Yes,
so
I know. It's like owned by Richemont.
So
that's right.
I work for Van Cleef, but we're owned by Richemont.
I have a friend who works for Richemont in Korea.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah. He's one of the watch guys, big watch guys.
Great.
Can you tell us a little bit about, look, because my wife, she's Korean. She loves Van Cleef & Arpels.
Oh, really?
Yeah, oh my God. If I could show you my Instagram, actually.
Okay.
So here, this is my card.
Okay.
You can check my Instagram there.
Okay.
This is my YouTube channel. I do a live streams about wristwatches, wristwatch hobby.
Okay.
We cover all the latest news. For example, earlier today, we analyzed that Rolex teaser.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, we identified all the new watches that are going to come out.
That's really cool. How did you meet Markus then?
I met Markus at the watch event.
Watch events? Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
I met him, and then I met him in Dubai, for Dubai Watch Week.
Oh, I remember. He went there. Are you going to Watches and Wonders?
Maybe. I am going. I'm
going
to live stream 10 hours a day. Every single moment, every single watch, we're going to see everything. So subscribe to the channel.
The thing is, I work at Richemont, so we actually get live streaming too.
Oh.
Because we're the main show there, right?
Wow, so. Yeah, that's right. I mean, all the Richemont, I'm really proud of that Richemont stuck around. Disappointed in Swatch, you know, they pulled out, what a weak move, and then they make plastic watches. Yeah, it's Richemont is doing it the right way, no shortcuts. What they're doing with Vacheron, what they're doing with the Lange, the jewelry brands, they're killing it. They know what the customers want and they're delivering it in a really like, man, everything they make is just so classic.
Yeah, I think that's really like, we want to stay true to the craftsmanship, the quality, the design, like
timelessness,
and not being too commercial. I mean, I know certain things are commercial, but certain maisons are still very true to the art and not focused on sales. Like, I mean, actually, it's not focused on the sales, really focused on the art.
Oh yeah.
Like at the end of the day, that is what we say in our company. Too. We're like, don't worry about
this.
Like, the CEO doesn't even ask about the sales.
Wow. It's about the passion.
It's really about, because he's a creative director of the brand, too. So he cares more about the art and staying true to the design, the quality, the craftsmanship, than the sales. But the sales come when you create a beautiful product that people want.
I totally understand what you're saying, because I'm doing, I have a little show, right? It's a small YouTube show, it's 100 people watching, right?
That's okay,
it's a tough market, right? And I had a similar issue, right? What do I do? Do I pursue what people want and like money? Meaning, do I do things that get me money immediately, or do I become a little more responsible? Don't chase money, focus on the subject at hand, and just believe that money will come in. Just trust in my viewers.
No, mine's a thing that you enjoy. You don't have to and you get really good at it. If you get really good at it, there will be no less competitors, and then money will come. Like,
exactly.
If you get on the top of your game, then money will come full want to either pay for your services or your talent.
Yeah.
So I really feel like, for me, at least working in what I do, like, it hasn't been about, of course I need to make enough to support myself.
Of course, everybody does.
Everyone, but it's never been about the money.
Making the best art that you possibly can.
Yeah, and being passionate about what you do. I think that's what has given me, like, value and feeling, like, accomplished.
Yes.
Sense of, like, yeah, that's actually
sense of accomplishment.
Sense
of that you're doing,
yeah.
That you're not just working for money, you're actually doing something that's meaningful.
Yeah.
And
I mean,
this is...
It doesn't seem cool. I mean,
yeah.
What we do, obviously, some people will judge and say, like, oh, this is, like, jewelry, and people don't actually need it to
people,
live.
People can always judge. But
yeah.
It, you know, it
but the thing
matter.
Is, if you can provide people, like, happiness
yeah.
when they look at their beautiful watch or their piece
yeah.
of jewelry.
Timeless design.
It's personal, too. It's something
yeah.
that you can wear every day. And, like, if you, like, have something that makes you happy, that's already enough. And then that can...
You know,
that has value.
You know what it is?
Yeah.
It's the people who, you know, you guys make beautiful jewelry. It's on other people how they choose to interpret it, okay? The piece of jewelry could be bought for a good reason or for a bad reason. It's my job to educate my audience to find special moments and celebrate those moments with beautiful jewelry that Van Cleef & Arpels makes, or Cartier makes, or the true Richemont brands make in general.
Yeah.
That's how I look at it.
No, I really appreciate
yeah.
your thoughts on that.
Yeah.
Like, no. I mean, I was, I guess before I worked there, I always loved beautiful design. I love watches and jewelry.
Yeah.
And then now that I'm able to be a part of the company, I think I'm even more, like, excited about everything that I do, because I get to be a part of, like, the creative and passionate people. Like, I would say most people that work at my company are there because they're
passionate.
Really. It's
yeah.
really the passion.
Yeah.
And that's what kind of keeps me going. And, like, when I wake up, I'm actually excited to go to work. And my company is actually, the people there are nice. It's not, like, a competitive environment. It's, like, not competitive, but, like, not catty, but it's just, like, a very, like, people are... Want
serious.
To be
they
want to
be the best.
They want to be the best. Of course, we have
yes.
a high standard for quality, but...
Yeah, the highest.
Yes.
I would say the highest.
Yeah, no, absolutely. I mean, the price point is high, so you need to...
Expectation.
The
on
standard
the other side.
Has to be high.
Yes.
Yeah. So everyone has a high level of standard, but you work with people that kind of think the same way that you do, then it's easy.
Mm. When you're on the same wavelength, you're working with people that want to achieve what you want to achieve. When you have people, a team that's going together with you, they're not holding you back, right? There's nobody who's kind of trying to bring you down. It's a
common passion,
common
goal.
Passion. Those jewelry pieces from Cartier and Van Cleef, they're not made by, like, one single person. It's an entire team,
yeah.
a body that
oh, yeah.
works to make those designs.
Oh yeah, it's a very long process. I mean, certain pieces can be made quicker, but definitely from design to production to completion, it's definitely passes through multiple hands and also quality inspection and standards.
You wanna give us a glimpse in, like, kind of what you do a little bit? I don't know what your part in the job. What do I do?
Yeah.
So
actually, I'm the director of supply chain. So I actually work with. I oversee our inventory, so our products. So this is, like, that's why it's kind of close to my heart, because
yeah.
the actual product and the quality and everything is kind of connected to what
yeah.
I do. I mean, I'm more the downstream planning. I don't necessarily do the production portion. I actually can't manage the planning and allocation for the boutique and the merchandising.
Yeah.
So what product should be at what source and what is kind of appropriate for each market.
Wow.
So
oh
based
my
on
God! Yes.
So you really have to know the market for the clients, what they're looking for.
These
so
kind
my
of
job is merchandising, it's planning because we're forecasting and doing all that for production purposes, and then that goes, of course, at the end of the day, and supports the boutique and supports the sales.
Wow, a lot of what we do on the show is speculate about what the future is going to be like. What new watches are going to be released, etc. on the show. What new jewelry, you know, okay, we're looking at which brands are up, which ones are down, which way the trend is going.
I don't know, what are you speculating on right now?
No, today Rolex dropped the teaser.
Oh, yeah.
Teaser. So we were speculating. I think I nailed it.
What was your guess on the
Rolex?
Yeah.
I think their highlight is going to be gold sky dwellers on presidential bracelet with open case backs.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's a very specific.
I think we nailed it.
I think we
were doing it on a live show.
Yeah.
I was bringing up a lot of stuff, and there was a lot of input. My watch community, they're most dedicated watch enthusiasts in the world.
Really? Okay. Are you a big collector? Or?
I'm a little collector.
You're passionate.
It's all about the passion.
Yeah, it doesn't matter how.
Yeah, I don't have a lot of money. I don't lie about my wealth.
That's okay.
I tell them as it is.
I'm not.
But you know, look at this. This is Maurice Grossman.
Oh wow, it's beautiful.
Yeah, it's insane. It's
a
handmade.
I like the dial.
I think Richemont should buy this brand.
Really?
Yeah. This is like Lange, but handmade, tremblage dial, hand-fired blue hands. The dial is made out of single block of German silver.
Okay.
So it's not, they're not applied, the numerals are not applied. They're made out of,
they're
cut
really?
Down. Yeah, it takes 5 days to make the dial.
So wait, how is it?
It's they take a plate and they start carving down into leaving the number.
And then leaving the numbers.
That's right. So it's hand chiseled and then hammered, and that's a handmade movement. That's right.
Wow.
Yes.
Oh gosh. Okay.
It's a manual wind. You can try winding it. So as you can see, the balance wheel is massive on this thing. Actually, let me flip it.
You
want
to show them?
Let's show them. I mean, they've seen it like a million times. They make fun of me for this watch. But it is extraordinary. As you can see, there's carving on the balance cock. So this is the wristwatch penis, so to speak. There's other key features that are exclusive to the Maurice Grossman.
Okay.
So, as you can see, the rubies, they're clear.
Yeah, I know.
And usually they're like...
usually the rubies or sapphires or some sort of colored stone.
Exactly, and it's completely different, right? So this is something they're doing different. It's got blued screws on the outside.
Is it numbered?
This is the number of the watch since production. So this is a very small quantity brand. This is in like 8 years, they made under 2,000 watches.
Okay, wow.
Yeah, and then you can see there's snailing here.
Uh-huh.
And it's got a very special movement. Okay, this movement is gonna blow your mind, okay?
Tell me about your
movement. Okay, this is why you have to buy this brand, okay. So, let's look here. What's your name again?
Eileen.
So this is what you do. What happens, this crown is very special. It's spring-loaded.
Okay.
So when you pull it out, it just goes back in. It doesn't stay out like normal crown.
Okay.
And what it does, it stops the movement. It hacks it. So when I pull it here, now the movement no longer runs.
Yeah.
You can see the running second stop. You can see the balance wheel stop.
Okay.
Now the crown acts as a setting. Now you can set the time.
Yeah.
Try how smooth that is. Try setting the time.
What time is it?
No, but just wind it. Like just turn the crown, how smooth it is, how good it feels.
It is very easy.
I'll give you a comparison here. I've got a Ming. This is a Ming. This is a $2,000 watch, okay?
Okay.
So what I want you to do by comparison, try Ming. Try winding.
Okay.
It's the same thing. Try setting the time.
This is how I normally kind of feel some other kind of
luxury.
Watches,
this is how you feel luxury, right?
Yeah.
So you can feel that is stiff.
Yes.
That is really stiff.
Yeah, this
balance
is very,
cock.
Very easy.
Very
smooth. How
smooth
that is.
How smooth is that? Tell them how smooth. Describe it.
I don't know. I don't even feel like it's like I feel like my hand, my fingers are just gliding through the crown and it just moves.
It just your fingers just glide through it. It's magical.
There's no, like, any type of, like, I don't even know how to describe it. It just moves.
It's luxury. That's how you describe it, okay? Luxury. Yeah, it feels luxurious.
Yes.
It feels.
And I would say that's what sets luxury apart from other brands. It's just that extra touch where it just the details
yes.
are noticed.
It's,
and everything is just like there's no what is that like
there's no negatives. There's nothing resistant.
Like,
there's nothing you don't like about it.
The entire experience is just very like seamless and smooth and like
yes.
makes sense.
There's no resistance. There's nothing that you
resistance.
Question.
Yeah.
And now to finish this presentation, watch what's gonna happen. I'm gonna turn it over for you. There's a little button there.
Okay.
Okay, now this button is very special. Let me just show. So this button is going to restart the movement.
Okay.
Usually, wristwatches, when you pull out, it stops the time, and then you have to push it in to restart it. And sometimes when you push it in, it jogs the hand, and it offsets it by like a minute.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. No,
it's bad.
I know what you're talking about. Yeah.
This movement is hack-proof.
Okay.
So now, press that little button. It's the most satisfying feeling ever.
Oh, look at it go.
Oh, and there it goes. Wow.
You have to set the time again, right? And then
it'll... That's okay. I don't set
the time.
But
look at the... Oh, is that the small
second? It's a small
seconds,
second.
Right?
Yeah.
Okay.
How cool is that?
Very cool. Thank you for introducing me.
It's my pleasure to show you a little, you know, watchmaker from Germany.
Yeah,
it's not a big... It's a female CEO as well. And I like to promote female, you know,
our regional CEO is female, but there's some other like major watchers that have female CEOs.
AP, just put a female CEO.
Exactly.
That's right.
Yeah, so.
They're, you know, because men pretty much tapped out.
JLC also has a female CEO. Like,
really?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, that's right. Well, there's a lot of them.
Yeah.
But from independent, she's the only one, I think. Those are bigger brands.
So, okay.
Yeah.
I need to look her up now.
Yeah, and Carter.
German,
Maurice
right?
Grossman. Yeah, you have my card there.
Okay,
you can reach out.
Know.
I'll help you with some details here. Yeah, you don't have nothing to worry about. So, yeah. Thank you.
Thank
I really
you.
Appreciate
it
you
nice
spending
time,
time with me.
Tim?
Sorry, what's your name again?
Eileen. With an A.
Alien.
It's Eileen with an A.
Eileen.
It's pronounced Eileen, but it's
Eileen.
Spelled with an A.
Eileen with an A. Okay.
Yeah.
Where are you from?
Where I grew up or?
Yeah, where you were born.
Or where the city is.
No, where were you born?
Oh, I was born in Texas.
Oh, that's very cool, Hanfa.
Where are you from?
I'm from Ukraine.
Oh, okay. Yeah. That's a little bit further.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. It's the opposite side of the
but
world.
You probably grew up.
I grew up in Brooklyn, so
okay,
I...
Okay, because you don't sound like you're from Ukraine.
I don't.
You don't have a Ukrainian accent.
I was there until 13 years old,
okay.
And I think my mother, she checked the website somewhere and she said, and it looked like if you bring somebody until they're 14, they won't have accent. And she timed it perfectly so I won't have accent when I come.
Yeah. You made it. You're here now.
Yeah. We're here.
Okay.
We're enjoying life and we're trying to spread the love.
Yes.
We'll watch people and the photography. Please enjoy your time.
Yes. No, I want to have a chance.
Say hello to Markus. There's Markus over
talked
there.
To him.
Oh,
already, of course.
Hey, talk to other watch people.
I don't know who else is.
Yeah.
Probably some of them have left already. So.
Yeah. Let's see. Oh, and make sure to get a refill. Get the rum. Get the rum in there. It helps.
I heard about this rosé, that thing. That I was like, I've never had this before. I just had my rosé.
You gotta try the rum. Try
the
rosé.
The rosé is good, so I don't even necessarily want to like alter it. You know, I'm very like true to. Like I'm a purist.
Yeah. Okay, that's good. Actually, you know what? That's kind of what the Cartier Van Cleef brands are. They're pure. They're not doing like some wild, crazy collab.
I mean, we're not like LVMH. We're not like collabing with everything. Like, Van Cleef would never. I can tell you, we would never do any type of like. We don't even make. We're not gonna make handbags. We're not gonna make sunglasses. We are jewelry makers, and we also have made watches for a very long time. So that's what we continue to do. That's we are just to our craft, yeah, exactly, to our brand, and we're not here to be commercial and make all these different products to generate more sales. It's really about just doing what you do and doing it well.
All the men that are watching, if they want to buy jewelry for their roommates, for their wives, they gotta get the bank plate.
If they can get it.
If they can get it. If they can get it. If they can get it, guys. And that's what you strive for. You gotta strive for. Actually, it's true. It's a true story. I went to buy, it's this wristwatch AD. That they told me they're not gonna sell me another watch until I buy jewelry. So I bought like one of their local. I bought a bracelet for $4,000 for my wife.
Oh my god!
With the, they had like a diamond, but it was a jewelry. It was the authorized dealer's brand. She hated it, but I gave it to my mom. So they were
okay,
my mom.
Someone appreciates it. Yeah.
It turned it, but I have to make it up for her. So. I'm gonna buy her a mattress, one of those Tempur-Pedic mattresses.
But those mattresses they get really warm too, so be careful. Like if you get like.
I don't want it because it's that memory foam. I don't trust it.
I mean, I use.
I like the springs.
Yeah. It gets very hot. So my cousin actually got a Tempur-Pedic mattress for him and his wife. And they were like so hot that they ended up getting rid of it because it's so expensive. And they thought it'd be so comfortable to sleep in, but get the one that is like.
You don't understand. She sleeps cold, so this is gonna be perfect for her. But I sleep hot, so I'm gonna die.
Yeah, you're gonna die. If we sleep together, then you should probably find something that works for both of you.
Oh no.
You want actually sleep better if it's a little bit cooler.
Oh yeah.
Your body temperature drops like 1 to 3 degrees before you fall asleep in a deep sleep, and it rises 1 to 3 degrees when you wake up. So it heats up when you wake up, and then it gets cooler when you fall asleep.
Would you recommend the springs or Tempur-Pedic?
I mean, I don't have a Tempur-Pedic mattress. I have a spring mattress. So.
Yeah, I think that's the way to go.
Yeah, I do have a Tempur-Pedic pillow because support, you know.
You like the proper support, a little bit of
but I think the mattress might be like too much. Like it's like I don't know.
Right, that's what I'm thinking. And then the price is like $5,000.
Yeah, I know.
For a memory foam mattress, you can get a Leica for that price.
Exactly.
Or a Rolex.
Yeah, you can get a watch.
Jesus.
But I do think that sleep is very important. You should definitely find a comfortable bed. Like, probably sleep is probably the most important thing you can do for your body. That's when you heal. And for your mind and body is connected. So.
But you know what? Look, we're in the Leica store where he took pictures with an automat with a film camera.
Yeah.
And to me, a spring mattress is like a automatic wristwatch or film camera, and the memory foam is like a digital one.
Oh,
it's
wow.
Integrated, right? I don't trust this technology. I don't believe it.
It's not. Just because it's more expensive doesn't mean it's better and it's
right?
For everyone. And that's what I agree. I think you really have to find something that you're comfortable with and that you like.
Yeah.
So.
I'm just glad it's not app integrated. Yeah, that would end me. Don't, guys, please, at the Richmond, don't do app integration into jewelry.
Oh, no. Please. We're like watchmakers, we're jewelry makers. You don't see that, like, technology and all that. Like LVMH has, like, NFTs and all. Like,
yeah, right. What the hell?
We're
NFT?
Like,
what
like,
the?
It's just very, like, I mean.
Cheesy.
People that like it, obviously, it's great. Like, they're in that world, but we're just.
Those NFTs are associated with scams.
Yeah,
why
exactly.
Would you put an NFT?
At the end of the day, a lot of it are scams. Like.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
That's a whole other conversation.
Well, I'm familiar with a lot of scams.
Oh, really?
Yeah, oh yeah, you know, there was wristwatch scammers. Do you know any wristwatch scammers? Do you know about the timepiece gentleman?
No.
He stole $5 million. And then there's this wizard. So, timepiece gentleman, he stole $5 million in wristwatches. And now he's in jail. He's awaiting trial.
I mean, he should be. He stole $5 million.
I know. But wait a second, there's a twist. The wizard, this motherfucker, he gave me a PlayStation and then he stole 400,000 from like some of the viewers who watched my show.
Oh my
and
God.
He's still not in jail.
Wait,
how is he not in jail?
Who
Because the wizard, the wizard.
Who's the wizard?
He's a Stefano Della Costa. He's a scammer, wristwatch scammer. He buys and sends. He basically says, "Oh, I'll buy that watch. Send it to me," and then he never pays you. What a scumbag!
Wow.
Yeah.
We gotta get this guy. He's like putting a black mark on the industry by like people who sell watches, making people be afraid to buy watches.
Well, we got a super chat, $28 more top content from the man Tim. Whoa, that's a super chat. Tell them to super chat.
What is a super chat?
Super chat is when I do a show and they pay me money. That's how I get paid.
Oh, wow. Good
yeah, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. It's like tips. It's like tips.
Oh, okay. So they send you tips. Cool.
Yeah. It's
so
hard.
You have to provide good, like, top content for them to...
Isn't this top content? This is fun.
And this is spontaneous because actually we just met.
We're talking jewelry, watches, into that kind of life even a little bit, right?
It's live, right?
Yeah, cheers.
Cheers.
To the watch community and the photography community.
So where is your audience mostly from? Like, where is everyone from?
Guys, type your flag in the chat. They're from all over the place. United States, UK, Australia, Canada. Uh-huh. I got some in Philippines, Singapore. We got Maldives. Shout out to Maldives.
Canada,
there you go. It's Canada too.
Vegas,
baby.
I'm going to Vegas in a week and a half, so I'll be there.
Oh, hey, Jimmy the Glock will take you to the bar.
Oh, where?
Yeah, and he has the best place.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
Yeah, you want me to set you
up?
Well,
we're opening a boutique at the Forum Shops, like a new boutique.
At the Forum?
At the Forum Shop. Well, we already have three boutiques in Vegas. We are converting one of the boutiques that was at Caesar's Forum Shops to our larger boutique. So
we love the Forums. We actually we like to hang out there. There's a pizza place on the corner there. Yeah.
Okay.
A friend of mine almost threw another friend into the fountain at the Forums. You know, the big, yeah. If you text me, I'll send you the pictures. You'll love it. You'll get him in there. It's funny, guys. Oh, look at this. We've got Venice.
Oh, I'm going to Venice in September for work meeting.
You go, girl. Cheers to Venice. Hey, there's a friend of mine, Oshino Mali. He's like number one wristwatch enthusiast YouTube channel.
Okay.
He lives there.
Oh, really?
Yeah. He'll take you out for the Spritz. You know the Spritz?
Yeah, for what,
Spritz Select. No, Spritz Select. Spritz Select. He's incredible.
Okay.
He's the dragon. He scares everybody here.
Okay.
You know,
this is actually really fun to be able to interact with people all over the world.
This is what the YouTube, kind of my little community, is all about.
Yeah, that's really cool.
Getting together. Yeah. We got friends all over the world. So whenever we go to some town, we got somebody there.
Do you meet people that you
all the time? All the time. There's this guy, Andy Benz. This son of a bitch. He lives in Brighton.
Okay.
He said, if I come to Brighton, he's gonna punch me in the face. And I said, let's fucking do it. I'll take you in the ring, man. And he's got a guitar. He's got this beautiful white guitar. His house was robbed. So what happened was, this artist, this guitarist, famous, world famous guitarist, gave him the guitar as a gift. You know, because his house was robbed.
Yeah.
So, but he said he's gonna punch me. So I said, let's set it up. Let's in the ring. Three rounds, 1 minute each, and then I'll put up my Panda Daytona. I have a Rolex Daytona.
Oh, okay.
And the winner takes the other person. So, guitar, if I win, if I beat him,
wow.
He's like 60 years old. No, it's a free guitar.
Yeah.
It's a free guitar. But Jake Paul is fighting Mike Tyson.
Yeah.
How's that fair?
That's true.
It's the same thing. It's the same thing. So I'm gonna beat up Andy Benz, take his guitar. Free guitar. I wanna.
Andy.
Yeah, he's a character. He's a character. He's a lovely guy. He sends me death threats all the time. Yeah. Tim, he said he's a Wing Chun master.
Oh,
you know the
Wing Chun?
Wing Chun.
Yeah, Wing Chun. That's like serious.
Is it? Is it really? I didn't think it was. Oh, because he's got...
What's his name? Oh, he's got Chinese actor who's like, he does Wing Chun.
Is it Jackie Chan?
Not Jackie. The other guy.
Chinese actor that does Wing Chun. Guys, in the chat, let's see it. But he does Wing Chun, and he said he's gonna send his brothers to kick my ass.
How old are his brothers? brothers. If they're like,
I don't know, they're probably like 80 years old, older than him, probably. I'll beat the shit out of them.
That's hilarious.
Yeah, it's just you.
Oh yeah, exactly. Ip Man. The actor for Ip Man.
Who's the actor for Ip Man?
Definitely. No, the actor.
Tom Wolf. Is it Tom Wolf?
The actor for Ip Man. What's his name?
Danny Yen.
Donnie Yen.
Let's go.
This guy. He's a big deal.
Oh, he's a Wing Chun master. Do you think he knows Andy Vince?
I don't think so.
You don't think so? Maybe Andy Vince can set us up.
He's like very top of this game. He's in a lot of movies too.
I think, you know what? If me and Andy Vince fight in the ring, If I fight against the Wing Chun master, if I beat Andy Vince, we can send that tape to Donnie Yen and say, hey Donnie Yen, look, I beat the Wing Chun master, now I wanna fight you. And then he's gonna kick my ass. Yeah, that would be fun.
He's pretty serious. But yeah.
I got enemies all over the world.
That's funny. Okay. Well, I'm gonna let you continue because I'm gonna look at all the photos.
Yeah, go around. Sorry for taking all
your time.
No,
that's okay. That was cheers. So fun. It was nice to meet you.
Cheers to the watch community.
It's so fun and cool.
I'm trying to be. No, it's jewelry. I have to make it entertaining. That's why I get paid the big bucks.
I feel like you can make anything entertaining. You're very vibrant. You have a very vibrant personality. Your energy is very bright.
Oh, thank you. I've been going through some stuff, but now I feel so, I'm on top of the world. It's good stuff.
Yeah.
If you're ever down, you want to know the secret to life, you got my number. Yeah.
Secret.
I know the meaning of life. I found the meaning of life. And if you want to know what the meaning is, give me a call, I'll tell you the meaning of life, okay?
Alright, I'll keep that in mind.
It's not a joke, it's true.
Yeah. Alright, it's so nice meeting you. Enjoy.
Thank you.
Have a good evening.
Thank
or
you.
Or have a good day wherever you are. Or just say hi to friends around the world. There's people from Venice, Canada.
Hi Venice, hi Canada. Yeah. What part of Canada?
Winnipeg.
That's West Canada.
West Canada.
Yeah. No, I know that.
Everywhere.
What's up, West Canada?
Yeah.
West
Vegas?
Canada.
We're
yeah,
in
Vegas
New York City.
Vegas City. Shout out to DC and LV.
Yeah, see Winnipeg.
Yeah. Winnipeg, let's go, Kyle D.
You're a philosopher monk?
I'm not. That's
what Dr. Bob's nightmare said.
He's just a funny guy. He's been funny.
I believe it. Dr. Bob, I believe it.
Man, he just smokes too much weed. Don't listen to Dr. Bob's nightmare. Yo, shout out to Dr. Bob's nightmare. I can't share the story. So you have to call me, private story about Dr. Bob's nightmare.
No, I don't. You gotta say
I met him in Vegas.
Someone wants to know the meaning of life.
I can't disclose that on the live.
You gotta call him.
Nobody's gonna believe me. Nobody is going to believe me. If I said the secret, nobody would believe me.
I probably wouldn't.
But hey, you got my number. Okay.
Do they have your number?
Yeah, you have my number, right?
I have it. Do they
want
to
have? Oh, they can become a member for $10 a month, and they get my membership. I mean,
and
you want to
tell them the meaning of life?
I'll tell them the meaning
of
life.
For just $10, okay.
For just ten bucks. That's the cheap.
That's
low tier membership.
Yeah. That's the second tier.
Oh, second tier. Okay.
Yeah, yeah. First tier is $4.
Okay.
And you get a $5 super chat. So it's like you're saving money by becoming a member. And you get the emojis. I got all kinds of cute emojis. Uh-huh. And people can spam the emojis.
Is this true, guys?
What?
I need to know if this is true.
What?
Are you just saying this? Or is
no,
this
I wish I was. I wish I was. Do I sound like I'm bullshitting?
No, that's the problem.
I am for real. I found the secret. It's very, it's so easy. It's so easy. I've been looking for the meaning of life for 3 years. For 34 years, right? And it's like,
you're so young.
Yeah, I'm so, I know, right?
You have a lot of life to live.
That's the thing. I think I found the meaning of life early. That's the thing. I think I found the meaning of life early. And if you guys give me a call...
The secret is ketamine and rock and roll.
Oh.
Hey, listen.
OC91, you're a wild guy. Or girl.
100% real. It's 100% real.
I really like that. They can just talk to everyone like live.
Yeah.
It's pretty cool. I've actually not done this before.
Done this before.
Not like this. So.
Well, the thing is, it's a double-edged sword.
Okay.
There's some nasty people out there. And a friend of a watch comedian, he was almost driven insane because he was doing this.
At a comedy.
Oh.
Yeah, because you can't,
hey,
like...
Don't be nasty, guys.
Yeah. Oh, oh! It's a gift for Aline! With an A!
We got a VIP! We got a VIP!
Wow. No way, Aline!
Should we open it live?
So unboxing! No, wait. We can ask for a super chat.
Wait.
It's money.
I had no idea I was here with a VIP.
Guys,
I'm over here on the chat.
Super chat now,
yeah,
for an unboxing. What could it be?
I don't know.
What could it be? I don't know what it is.
I don't know.
I'll tell you, here's the thing. If they super chat, like, I don't know, $50, I'll tell you who... look, they could do $500.
Man. Oh, wow. Okay.
Some of these cats, it's like $500 is like nothing for them. So,
okay.
Hey, but we got OC with the $2. Thank
you.
Yeah, it is sweet.
I made $2.
Aline unboxing. Aww. And we're going to do unboxing. Let's
oh, what's
do
that?
It.
No, that's just a
Z-Man.
Yeah,
Z-Man.
A joke.
We like
yeah.
it.
Yeah.
Oh, we got another $2.
St. Peter, another $2.
Wow. You're very generous.
That's how I make my living. Right? There's moments and I... Mikey, look at this. Mikey has been a member for 28
wow,
months.
Wow, you're like a loyal,
yeah.
loyal.
Mikey, welcome to Leica Soho.
Yeah, he was a story editor. That's the second level. That's the $10 level. He's a good guy. And he says, I'm true. I paid $10 a month for 28 months.
Worth every penny. That's
you see
that's
that?
That's the point. That's the key part.
Whoa, we got Chungster with the $20
wow.
super chat. Here you go, Timmy. Thank you.
Wow.
Hell yeah, guys. Look, we made some money. Dr. Bob's Nightmare, $5.
He gave me... Wait. Time out. You gave a model?
No. He's joking. He's joking. He's a, that's what I'm saying. And we got 209, $10 super chat. Dude!
Wow, this is like crazy.
Hell yeah.
Good He's, job. I mean, like, wow.
There you go.
You know, it's like random, like, running and meeting you. And
you just made my day. You just made some money for me.
Sweet.
You do an incredible job for Richmond. Without you, these guys wouldn't have the incredible jewelry that the brand makes. Right? You're part of, you know, making it happen.
I mean, they do something special
yes.
for other people, I'm sure, too. And they're an important part of their company, their family. So everyone, as long as they contribute.
It's a team effort.
It's a team effort. You're doing something.
Just like this show, I wouldn't be able to afford to be here. I mean, what the hell? I mean, I have to get, you know. And it is so cool. I'm so glad to be able to bring. Let's show them.
All right.
What is
it? So, I just got this from Markus.
Shout out to
Markus.
Markus. He's a mysterious
guy. Should we
open the
card
guy. Oh, he's a card.
Thank you, card.
I didn't get
thank
this.
Thank you for what? I mean,
oh,
I was
thank you
student.
For being here, for being you.
Oh, thank you for your continuous support.
Oh.
He's very sweet, honestly.
So Markus, sweet.
That's so sweet.
Markus is a really good guy.
He's a very good one. Oh, wow.
Oh,
I got it.
Oh, no. Wow. You got a print?
I got a print.
A photograph.
Beautiful. I actually need
yes.
more artwork, photography for my apartment. So
you know what? This picture you're gonna remember when the earthquake happened. You see this? This is Earth and the sky separating.
Yeah.
This is what happened in New York, and you got this photograph
yeah.
on the day.
Yeah, today we
that
had an
New
earthquake.
York earthquake happened.
And then
this
I got.
Special. What is
of
this?
Of course, a watchanista.
A watchanista. Are you a watchanista?
Well, I've been to their events, and I'm a watch person, so yes.
A little bit.
Oh,
yeah.
Wow. That's just nice of him. I mean, honestly, just being thoughtful.
Yes.
It's like what I care about. When someone gives you a gift, it's really the thought behind it. And, you know, he knows I like watches, and he gave me something special.
A photograph. How is this picture special to you? What do you see in this photograph?
Well, when I see this photo, I think of like actually him being there, taking this picture. I think about that moment when he was climbing Kilimanjaro. Which I think is super impressive and like an amazing feat.
Of
it's
strength.
A feat, like for anyone to do, but for him to even have the conceive the thought to want to do that, like I'm very proud of him. I think I honestly think it's like
it's amazing. An incredible
it's an
achievement.
Incredible achievement.
And he wore his watches too to climb it.
He did.
Yeah.
He wore his. His watches.
He's a true
and he made it back too. So
yeah.
Now we have beautiful photographs.
You have to ask him to sign it on the back somewhere.
Oh,
just in case,
you
know,
like
that would be,
Then it's worth a lot more when he becomes like.
He's gonna become legend. Look,
yeah.
I'm not kidding.
Yeah.
Earlier today, see it.
Yeah.
Oh, that was here. I was here in the morning.
Did you guys see this?
I was trying to introduce him to a friend of mine.
Okay.
And we came here to get like a sneak preview. And I bought one of his prints, so I was just.
Oh, you did?
I did in the morning.
I
yeah.
Love that.
Yeah.
I love that.
And when I thought of buying it, that's when the earthquake happened.
Wow.
This guy's
so
gonna change the world. He's gonna change. He's gonna.
The world is
shake
shaking.
Up. He's gonna shake up the world.
This was an earth shaking
show.
It's
scary.
Man.
It's scary. I got the shivers. I was like.
Wow.
My viewers didn't believe it. They thought, fucking Tim.
No, we got a big earthquake and our buildings were like swaying and like everyone felt it, I feel like.
Where were you then?
I was in my apartment, but.
What were you doing?
Working, but I could feel my apartment building like moving.
Yeah.
And I was just like, I thought it was an explosion, but then it was like lasted longer and I was like, okay, this is.
You gotta shake up response. You gotta shake it up. You gotta shake it up. It's a sign.
That's
you gotta
sign.
Do it. Yeah. It is. You gotta keep going up there. You know. You got the spirit. You made it this far. Okay? You gotta keep the fight.
Keep the fight.
Climb the ladder.
You should get in here. You're like.
No. I like being on the side.
Oh,
I'm a cheerleader.
No. You're awesome.
I live in New Jersey, guys. We had an earthquake today.
Yeah. What happened to you?
Tell us there.
I thought my building was going to collapse.
Yeah.
I'm not
like,
gonna lie.
What were you doing?
I was watching First Take.
A what?
A sports show. A sports talk show. Yeah.
You're watching sport. Have you ever wanted to play some kind of sports that you've been neglecting?
I should have went to the NBA, guys.
Should have.
I know. You
could have.
You're tall. How tall are you?
Yeah.
He's a mountain.
Oh, yeah,
no, I'm not that tall. I'm not.
tall. He's like Kilimanjaro.
That's my Kilimanjaro.
Wait.
Yeah.
Oh.
Oh,
shoot.
Oh,
no,
shoot.
No, no.
Hold on.
What happened?
There we go. We're back.
He's like Kilimanjaro.
No,
yeah,
I'm not
he's
that
pretty
tall.
Yeah.
I mean, look at me. I like this.
How tall are you?
I'm 5'4".
Oh, is this 5'4"?
You're not 5'4".
I'm 5'4" with heels. I mean, no, with heels, I'm higher. With heels, I'm like 5'7". Maybe.
Let's do shoe check. Let's
That's,
go. Shoe
it's
check.
It's just a... It's
Let's
a
see.
It's
Let's see. Oh, it's cute. Whoa. Side by side. Let's see side by side. Wow. Yeah. Oh, my God. This is like... Yeah, look at the... It's the heel. That's a sexy heel, yeah. Wow. Wow. Oh, what is that? Ooh, let's see the jewelry check. The jewelry.
Some Cartier.
Oh, my God.
This is Bulgari.
Ooh.
Whoa.
This is
Vincent.
This is Zodiac.
That is so beautiful. Is that your animal, like a...
My Zodiac.
What is that? That looks like a horned animal,
yeah.
Like a goat. A goat.
What's the goat?
What is the
goat?
An aquarium.
What does the goat do? You're a what?
No, not the aquarium.
No. I'm a horse. Wait, no.
You made that up.
Oh no, sorry. I'm Aquarius actually. Yeah, I'm Aquarius. February 3rd.
Yeah, February 3rd.
A goat is...
A goat.
A
goat is, it's like June, July, one of those months.
What does she think of Piaget? We actually, Piaget is also part of our company.
That
Richemont
is such a sexy bracelet. You have one for every zodiac
sign. I'm a horse. That was
Aries.
A goodie.
No,
I'm
not Aries. I'm a Capricorn.
Capricorn. Oh, I love Capricorn.
Oh, really? What are you?
I'm a Virgo.
Oh, then we get along.
Yeah,
we're Earth
yeah,
signs.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. We're here.
Wow, Aries.
No, it's a Capricorn.
It's a Capricorn. Which month is that?
December, January. So we're not too far apart.
Oh, yeah. Right. We're like,
you're the next one after me.
What is your animal known for? What's that say about you? What kind of personality do you have?
Honestly, it's always about like working, hard working.
Oh, like you're stubborn. You got those horns.
No, that's... Oh,
right? Like you got the horns.
No. It's just like always working, ambitious, and actually liking nice things, but like nice quality things. So having a high standard.
Yeah. Makes sense. Yeah. Makes sense. What can you tell about Aquarius? What are they like?
You're like a water sign.
I'm like a water, yeah.
So you're like probably a little bit more like...
So just go with the flow? I don't know.
I think a little bit more cerebral.
Cerebral?
Yeah, wow. Like a little bit more like...
Nobody ever said that before. Thank
yeah.
you.
Yeah, cerebral,
thank you. I'm
like,
cerebral, guys. You heard it from the lady. Cerebral right here.
It is. I mean, I think you're more like connected to your emotions, maybe creative.
A little bit.
Yeah, a little bit creative.
By the way, this look, what do you think about the look?
I mean, it goes with the cerebral look. You just let it flow.
Just let it flow. Fuck it. I don't
care.
Be yourself, honestly. But I do appreciate fun wristwatch making.
I know. You got like a double.
I figured it's a watch event.
I mean, it's watch people at a photography event.
Yeah. A little bit of that. It's pretty cool.
Yeah. All right. I'm going to let your viewers see something else.
Thank you so much. No, you didn't take my time. Yeah. I'm taking your time. What are you talking about? Thank you so much.
No.
Really
so
appreciate
nice
talking to you.
Thank you for sharing your walk with me and like sharing your audience with me.
Oh, it's my pleasure.
Yeah.
You're always welcome to join us in the chat. Or if you want to join us on the stream.
Cerebral assassin.
Yeah, I don't read the chat. You can never read the chat. The cerebral means insane.
Cerebral, I think you're connected to your thoughts, your emotions, like your... Is that kind of like what you're like or no? I don't know.
I wasn't until like 5 days ago.
Why? 5 days?
I didn't know who I was. I didn't believe in who I was. And then, when I went to D.C., I understood my purpose in life. And it all made sense after that. And
well, I'm glad you found yourself. And you found your purpose.
And I found the meaning of life. So give me a call if you want to. Whenever you're ready.
I love this.
Put it in somewhere there with the photographs.
I have
somewhere.
It in my bag already. I just put it in my bag.
Don't do it yet. Do it in like 5 years when you forgot, when this is just a distant memory. Where you're, you know, when all hope is gone, take out and you just, Tim, what is the meaning of life?
All right. When I am lost,
yeah.
I'll text you and ask you.
But,
what should I do?
Yeah, but also feel free to always pop in the chat, say hello, just put a bunny ears in the chat, or join us on the show to just talk about wristwatch.
Well, I've been on your
You already did.
I've been on your show for the past like half an hour, 20 minutes.
Oh, I think we were on an hour and a half.
Oh no!
You gotta get out.
What time?
It's time is flying.
I'm like,
go
sorry
mingle,
for
go
asking
mingle.
Too much of your time. Go back to the event.
Cheers
to everyone that's watching.
Good time.
Thank you. It was so nice meeting you.
Thank you for joining us on the stream.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Ta-da. Okay, let's point the camera this way. Wow, that was quite an experience. Eileen, everybody. She is amazing. Eileen. What a sweetheart. Thank you. Let's get another victim. Yes, as OC would say. Cheers.
Ah. Of course, these are amazing. You want to talk some watches? I'm doing a live stream. You wanna introduce yourself? Yeah, wristwatches, photography, Leicas. Hello. What's your name, sir?
Kai.
Yes.
Kai.
How did you find out about this event?
Through Leica.
Through Leica? They advertised it.
They did. They posted on their Instagram.
Very cool. What did you think about the event?
Lovely. The story is
very
quite
cool.
Honest, very moving. It's fantastic.
Very cool. Now, are you a Leica shooter?
I am.
Tell us about your camera. Hey, we got just real quick, we got a super jet hit, $2. Tim, aka Casanova, aka McDaddy, aka Hugh Hefner. Okay. The Jokers, thank you.
We're live.
You kind
of surprised me. Live.
You guys don't look very
live. We're live.
Sorry.
No, it's so cool. I don't want to drop it. Wait, Kai, tell us about your camera. You're a shooter. Do you have a collection? Are you an enthusiast? You have an Instagram account where people can go check out your program?
I do have an Instagram account. It's Kai Normanha, CaeNormanha, and I do love Leicas, and I've been shooting.
Who wants to get in touch with me?
Where is he?
See, they're getting pizza, that's what they're doing.
Okay. That's fine. Okay. That's fine. Yeah, they're getting pizza. Why can't they just chat me in the chat, right? It's all cool. Shoot me your Instagram. I'll promote it on the channel, obviously. Oh, no, there's doxing. There's trolls that want me dead. I got
enemies there.
Oh, I got enemies on every continent.
That's good.
Dude, there's a guy that wants to kick my ass in Brighton.
Hey, if you're doing something wrong or something right, as long as they're getting a reaction, you're moving people, and that's what artists do.
Exactly. We're here to move some people. How are you moving people with your photography? What are you interested in?
I'm interested in recording anything that strikes my attention. I have a genre. If we go up to a mountain, we go up to a mountain. If we're in the middle of 42nd and 5th, we are over there in the middle of chaos, and we get what we get. We just record the memories that comes to our path.
Wow.
To the journey.
You have a photography book that you're working on. You have some projects.
That's it. Yeah, I am working on a book.
Hey, by the way, OC, text Eddie Mao. Tell him that I'm in the store.
We get pizza later.
Yeah, we'll get pizza later. Uh-huh. You're working on the book?
Yeah, I am working on a book.
Oh.
How much coffee do you drink? You've been talking the whole time I was here before.
You must be dehydrated.
I'm doing a show.
Sorry.
It's okay.
But I want that coffee.
Yes. No. Yeah. Big deal. I'm actually going to have to go, guys.
Oh, when you're working on the book, we got your Instagram. You got my number.
Yes.
If you're interested in watches, you know what? Yeah. What you got there? Oh, IWC, and then we've got Victrinox. Victrinox. Very nice. And this is a Tremblage Maurice Grossman.
And a Ming.
If you need help with watches, you got my number.
That's the man.
Get it done. Cool.
Thank you.
Just a second. Oh! No. It's okay. It's all cool. Yeah, it's just sometimes this happens. Oh, thank you. No problem.
I got that. Keep going.
You got it?
No.
You got it?
We don't allow that.
I got it. Hey, I want to help out a little bit. Look, I made the mess. I really... I really appreciate you guys helping me, you know, allowing me to stream here. I don't want to be making mess for you guys. You've been so kind to me. Hey, just a second. So
these are all, are they?
These are digital. These are digital. So as you can see here.
All of these are digital?
Yeah, all of these are digital. No. I think, yeah, actually these are all digital. Even this one, it doesn't have a back screen. It's still digital. Because it's like designed to take pictures in a, like a non-digital way. To make shifting. Okay.
So you don't cheat.
Exactly. It's like for enthusiasts, you know.
Like a true art form.
Some people wanted to make their watch photography even more challenging for themselves, do it with a certain way, with certain approach to it. And these Leicas allow people to do it in like that old school way where you couldn't do a certain, you know, where a computer didn't help you.
Right.
Yeah. So these are really cool. Yeah.
Love it.
Are you a watch enthusiast, by the way?
Not really.
No?
I mean, I like watches, but I don't wear one anymore. But yeah, I like watches.
Okay, look, I'll give you my card. I do a wristwatch show. If you ever consider buying a watch, check out my channel. We're just a group of guys, like, talking watch. We've got 100 people watching, you know?
Okay.
Yeah, it's just a great chat group about watches and, like, all cool luxury kind of things.
Nice.
Yeah.
Business card. I like it.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. It's season 4. I've been doing this for 3 years. Make sure to check us out. Hey, let's see. Because my friend. Yeah. I'm careful. Let's see here. I need to do something. Yeah. Enjoy the show. This is incredible. Hey. Where's Markus?
A second.
Yes.
Yo, I just wanna. I don't know if there's
anything. Yes,
I'm gonna go across the street to have some tacos.
He's going
with
to
my
have
friends.
Tacos, okay?
Yeah. But
thank you for coming.
No, but maybe we'll meet up afterwards. But I wanted to pay for the print. This is $100 here.
Oh,
cash.
Yes. He bought a print.
This is for you.
Thank you very
That's
much.
For the print. Okay?
He gave it to me.
There you go.
We owe you $25 now.
No. It's with taxes plus tips, okay?
Oh, so I get a tip, guys. Did you hear that?
You got a tip. You're
just
an
artist. Me on a photo.
Jealous.
All right,
man. We got a cougar alert. Okay, Mathis. Where's Mathis?
Oh, what the fluff?
No,
it's
my friend. It's my friend. My friend likes cougars. He's a great enthusiast of cougars.
What's your name? Zag actor Madeline Russell at your service.
Say, Mathis, I love you.
Mathis, I love you. Tell him to give me a honey now.
Get some honey, Mathis. Get over here. Whoa! Okay, see now I understand why Mathis loves cougars. I totally get it now. I get it. It all makes sense. I get it. I figured it out, guys. I found it. I found the why it happens. Excuse me. Can I get my jacket? Okay, let's just. Okay, guys. Let's leave this place. Let's go say hello to the boys.
It's so much fun. It's it reminds me of like New York.
All right. We're out. Where did they go? I should have had one more glass of rosé. Before leaving the place, to be honest. Oh, where are they? Maybe it's over there. Oh, I can hear my name. I can hear my name. It's this way. Woo! Ow, 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 ow! Oh, it's this way. Ow, ow, ow! Oh, I think I can hear it. I can hear it, guys. It's this way. Follow the owl sound. Interesting. Where is it? Ow! It's a cross. I think it's a cross. Oh, I can see it. I can see it. Yeah. All right. Let's go. We found them. Okay. All right. We are reunited yet again, boys. Let's go here. Let's go through the cars. Shit. Fuck. Look at this Corvette. God damn. Yo, nice Corvette, guys. Holy shit, that's the good one. Whoa, he just took off, man. Okay. Let's go here. What's happening in there? What the? This is just ridiculous. Okay. Wait. I think I'm. Are they inside? Oh, Dos Caminos! Oh, I get it. Okay, Dos Caminos. Hi. Excuse me? Okay, sorry. Hey, are you alive?
Hello.
I guess we're gonna say hello.
Yeah, I wanna be in it.
Come say hello.
What's up? We're live.
They like girls. They're watch enthusiasts. Just tell them how much you like watches, okay? Here, just hold it for a second. I want to take off your jacket.
We love watches. Is that what you said?
Yeah. Just play it up.
Love to tell the time. Yeah. I personally, my favorite is a Rolex.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
What brand do you like? Oh, hey. Almost there. You like Rolex? You like Patek Philippe?
I don't know if this goes on. Hey. Sorry. Are you Michigan?
Yeah.
That's so cool. Go Blue.
Thank you.
Now it's unlocked. Go Blue.
Oh, God. What is this? What is happening?
Yeah, you guys are...
Oh, here.
100 people watching.
Here's the card. Here's the card.
Oh, thank you.
Wristwatches. Hey, what is this? Taco night? What is happening?
Whoa.
Sorry.
No face.
It's just me and the girls, okay. Hey, what can I put in here? Yeah? Thank you. Wow. This is my taco?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Chips.
And chips. Oh, I'm gonna dig into those chips. I'm hungry AF.
Need some ASMR with some chips.
Yeah. Some chips here. Some chips in the house. Yo, chips in the house. It's cool. It's happening. It's what's up? Photography event. Scrounger. I get it. Photography event. Scrounger. You hear about this new nickname?
I hope you got some free Leicas. I hope you scrounged some Leica cameras.
What do you think, guys? What do you think about the event?
With this photo.
What?
With the printout.
It's already home.
Oh.
Well, I bought it during the day. And then took it home. And I came back. What'd you guys think about the event? It's cool? Interesting, right? It's I want SmallG to put an event like that. Did you see his IG?
What do you drink?
Scotch and soda. Small G. Yeah. Thank you.
Go ahead, Jessica. She got you.
That's it?
Are you full?
Should we do another one? We had a bunch of tacos, but we're still hungry.
You guys have what? What is happening in here?
Everybody wears black.
Is this like a special bar?
Yeah, it's a place to be.
You want more food?
I'm coming back here.
Yeah?
This is a great gonzo place.
I
thought the chicken tacos were good.
You want to get some chicken and some beer, yeah?
Whatever you want. I know Eddie drinks this whole fucking place. Nice. I need another drink. I think we should check their IDs.
How's the taco?
Yeah.
Ballers. It's really good. The taco is amazing.
Dude, I like the beard, man.
You like it?
Yeah.
I'm going to trim it down on Monday into like a Sean thing. Yeah. Glass it up. I'm going to wear a sports coat and shit to watch his wonders. And bunny ears.
No bunny ears.
Oh, come on.
Makes
a
little sense.
Come on, man.
Sorry, can we order some more?
Yeah.
So you got the whiskey, was the whiskey,
Scotch. Oh, actually, can I get a glass of rosé?
Yeah.
I'm drinking rosé tonight.
Rosé Paul.
I had some over there. Might
you
as well.
To give it.
Keep it going, right? Now, mixing. If I start mixing and matching, I'm going to get fucked.
Can I do another margarita? Can I get salt?
Yeah, would you like tahini or regular salt?
What's
that? Would
you
like
a
spicy chicken?
And then, how many tacos come in a chicken order?
Chicken tacos? Yeah, the photos were cool.
Can I do one good. More order of chicken?
Right? Yeah. It was exciting to see someone in the watch community put something like this together. Okay. It's just respect.
Yeah, he had the great stories.
His grandfather's camera was there. Exhibit.
Do you have any feedback?
Yeah.
I have some feedback. I'm going to talk to him in private. I got a ton of feedback for him.
He needs to be charging more money for his photographs. if you can walk out with the print for $80, what'd you pay?
$75.
Great
I gave him
great deal.
$75 plus tax, and I gave him a tip. I gave him a $100 bill.
I saw that you handing him actual money. We were watching the stream while we were.
Thank
you.
We need
to make sure you're okay.
That's your guys' money. You know that, right?
Sure.
That's your guys' money. Our money.
Sure it is.
Our money.
Our money.
Somebody's buying.
We have a shared bank account.
It's like a shared bank account, basically. All my money is basically your guys' money. Because yours says, that's just my salary. It's your guys' money. Those super chats, the memberships, your money is my money. So I'm like you. In a way.
Look at my wife.
Cool.
Take all my money.
It's our money. It's my
money. It's
our
money. Their money.
They just keep coming in.
Oh my god.
The black dress.
Oh my god.
Every single one. Do you want to show the group?
Bring it in. Oh, that's funny stuff. Bloodland 99, $5 super chat. Hey! Bloodland 99, $5. Yeah, I know, right? I should put it like this. Like this. Whoa. Yeah, this is a single. Guys, if you're single, if
and
you want to get really
high school. If you're single and you're in high school, this is the place to come.
It's the place to be.
Like when you're in high school, you don't have money.
If you play varsity sports, this is the bar for you.
Wow.
How can we do in high school without any money?
Yeah,
what can we do?
Meet some cool older watchmen who will pay for all those races.
Become a watch flipper. Easy.
How can we afford?
Yeah. High school was tough.
Yeah, no.
It was hardcore. For
not
me.
The glory days.
Actually, I had it easy, guys.
I loved high school.
You know, in the United States, high school, I wasn't bullied. That was the amazing part.
In New York, New Yorkers don't bully.
That's the thing. It was a breeze.
Not in New York. New York public schools, there's no such thing as bullying.
Really?
I don't think so.
No, I wasn't. I mean,
nobody was. I don't think anybody was.
Oh, it's amazing.
That's more of like a suburban thing, you know?
Bothering
Magic the Gathering. Yeah, right? No, because school leaves and you just, you know.
Because I watched the American movies, and how in movies there's always a school bully,
And I thought, wow, well, I'm so lucky. At least I'm not being bullied at school.
There's always one asshole.
Yeah, yeah.
And then you see him at the reunion and you're like, oh, and then you realize you're doing better than him.
Oh!
He's wearing a T-Salt. <T-Salt. laughs> Calvin. Michael Kors.
Five kids and eight.
And a wife
that hates him. He stayed for a year for that watch. You
got your
shit up.
It's a two-tone Michael Kors watch.
Hello.
I think this is like... They're younger than Colin. They have to be.
That's what?
They're going to say... They're going to say... 21.
So what did you guys think? How was the event? Hey, Eddie, how was your? Have you ever went to a photography event like this?
Never, first time.
So
no, I felt. I gotta check if I have a trust fund now. I feel like I might have inherited a trust fund.
Really?
Walking in there.
Ooh. It's pretty. Look.
Those cameras are not cheap.
Oh, yeah. Wow, you took some pictures? Where's this? This is you? Wow. Holy shit. Send me those pics. Wow. Yeah. Would you... What do you think? Would you ever summit the Kilimanjaro? What do you think?
Is it bad that I don't even know where that is?
Africa.
That's in Africa?
Yeah.
No. I do the Himalayans. Which one's harder? Everest is harder?
Everest is way harder.
Yeah, I do Everest. Everest, yeah. Go big or go home.
That's where Explorer 1 is.
If you're gonna climb a mountain and you're gonna tell your kids I climbed the mountain.
Better be deep
fucking Everest.
Yeah.
If a guy could do it with a 50-year-old grandma camera.
So what do you think? Is this where Marcus's destiny lies? In Everest? Does he have to chase Everest with the camera? Is that where the journey goes? This is where.
I see a theme. There's a theme there, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Step by
yeah.
step.
Yeah.
The highest. That's the top.
He has to keep working at it until he summits Everest with that camera.
You think the camera will work up there?
Yeah.
You think it will like freeze up like the...
No, you can keep it protected.
Yeah. Yeah, that's why
he brings
whole batteries. Because he's using a film camera.
I think that's where the destiny, that's his destiny. He said he doesn't know where he's going. Hey, listen, he doesn't have to climb Everest next year, but like in 10 years, I mean, he can build his way up there. Kilimanjaro is a great way to start.
It's a great starter mountain.
Yeah, great starter mountain.
Yeah.
Right?
It's like a Tudor.
Yeah, it's a Tudor. Tudor mountain.
Tudor in the mountain.
Yeah,
Tudor.
Yeah.
There's no Daytona.
Ain't no Daytona.
Ain't no Patek.
No, ain't no Patek. No.
That means like Bear Mountain or Tim Heights is like...
That's a G-Shock. That's a G-Shock.
No, that's not even...
That's a Happy Meal watch.
Yeah.
I think you offended him.
What?
I'm sorry, Tim. He didn't mean that.
What? Wait, no, you didn't offend me.
Kilimanjaro is
yeah.
Tudor. What is Bear Mountain? Swatch Watch?
Moon Swatch.
Just so, man. Well, Moon Swatch? No, worse than that, man.
Bear Mountain's pretty
good. Bro, this is like the... That Nico Leonard watch with two middle fingers facing yourself. That's the... Incorrect.
Oh, it should be the other way.
No. The only way you can get that image is if you're doing it this to yourself. That's for who the watch is. For people who are so dumb.
Devil's advocate. Unless you're driving and the dude behind you is being a dick.
What?
Oh.
Are they familiar with Nico's watch?
Nico's watch? Oh my god. Too middle. No.
How many do you like?
80?
What is the most popular watch they had to name a popular watch brand?
Yeah. I'm looking for opportunity. If I see opportunity, I'll.
Eddie Mavs, please come.
Yeah?
I just bring up TikTok.
Bring up the TikTok.
TikTok and Snapchat, they go crazy. Disney kids and
Goldfinger says, "Hey Tim Wright, is that Eddie Mao with you? If it is, fist bump, Eddie Mao. Boom, there you go. It is." It really is Eddie Mao, the legend. Yeah, listen. I think SmallG, his photography has gotten so good lately on the Instagram. I don't see why not. We can do an exhibition there of his photography. He takes his pictures with a Leica. Shit, yeah. That's a cool event, man. You gotta.
I'll put my title.
Yeah.
Me and my grandfather.
Me and my grandfather.
Me and my
stream. I gotta tell you guys a hilarious story, but off stream.
Oh.
Yeah.
Hilarious about watching it.
All right, maybe we should shut it down.
Yeah, okay.
Unless someone gives $100 super chat.
Unless it's $100 super chat. Look, we'll go next. Every 10 minutes going forward, it's $100 super chat. We're gonna do 10 more minutes, and then actually 16 minutes. That's gonna be 200 minutes. No, it's too long. Is it? Do you have to go?
Yeah. No, I
got
it.
I don't care. Hey, listen, I'm here for the boys. Eddie Mao is there for me when I needed him. Dude, that meal with the roommate. Oh my god! Really, thank you.
The Thai?
Oh, dude, if you're ever in Brooklyn, you gotta try it. It's like it should be Michelin star.
Where in Brooklyn?
Next to Prospect Park.
Oh shit!
Yeah, on the bottom part of Prospect Park. So good. Roommate's like, why is this not Michelin star? It's like presentation, everything.
I love Thai food.
Oh.
Love Thai food.
It's the Cars and Chrono got me hooked on it.
On Thai?
Because he had the event, like the second event, Watch Community Me, at the Thai place. But then Red Shovel ruined it because Red Shovel was like, I don't eat Thai. I don't eat the. He half the food. He's like, I only eat steaks and French fries.
He only eats food that's gray and soggy.
Steak and French fries, that's it.
What do British people. Oh, he's not British, he's Irish.
He's Northern Ireland. That's where they built the Titanic.
Oh shit, that's why it fell? It always sank?
Yeah. Yeah, but he's the hardest working plumber. And, hey, Watches and Wonders are coming. Hi.
It's her first day on the job.
First day on the job?
He's on YouTube.
I get it, I know how it is. It's my first day live streaming.
Is it Thursday?
No. I know, but... Whoa, we just got $100 super chat. That's insane. What the F? $100.
Is it for the tip for the waitress?
Tim is going to pay for taco.
See, we get $100 for the waitress.
$100. Hey, see, can we get one more hundred for the waitress? Guys, $100 for the waitress. Come on, don't be cheap.
Somebody will do it.
Don't be cheap. Yeah. And if you could do more, do more.
Do more.
I'm gonna clean you this up.
Oh, thank you.
Okay. Thank you so much. Are you doing okay?
It's unbelievable.
Where are we at?
Yeah,
we're good, yeah.
We are. 100, come on. One more 100.
It's her first day on the job.
It is?
Yeah, that's why, you know.
Wow, yeah.
Bless her on the first day, you know. And yeah. First day on a Friday, too, which is like.
This is a hard day.
Busy, you know.
Man. I don't know. These girls are not 100%. They're too young. They could screw up somebody's day real quickly. But they've been behaved. So, no ruckus here. Pretty cool. This is a cool place. Actually.
going on in the back?
Push on to these chips.
Alright, well.
Well, I know where I'm going. I'll see you guys later.
Jonathan Smith says, what's on the wrist? Oh my god, the Daniel Katz and Bondage and Discipline, the Maurice Grossman. Hey, Eddie Mount, what do you got there on the wrist? Let's see that. I'm gonna flip this. Oh, a Planet Ocean, very nice. This is like a vintage piece. Is that a Omega strap? Whoa, proprietary. Nice. Wow.
8500 movement, so it's yeah. The thinnest.
Nice.
Thinnest Planet Ocean with the ceramic
bezel.
Yeah. Only, I think only 1900 pieces. 1900 pieces.
Wow. Yeah, that is a great
this
one.
This is the holy grail of Planet Oceans. Like this is like the.
Wow.
You know. Yeah.
Wow.
It's a good watch.
Guys, if you want to be just as cool as Eddie, motherfucking Mal, get this watch. It's Omega. This is so discreet, too. Like, if you're doing a job that you're not going to make. Yeah. What's the look?
Look at the case.
Case?
Try to scratch it with your finger. You feel anything?
It's beat the shit.
No. Feel it.
What is it?
It has a protective.
Oh, it's plastic. You gotta.
I bought it from. He put a sticker on every single link, front, side, and back.
Wow.
And a metal bracelet. And
wow. That's obsessive compulsive.
Dude, this watch is minty underneath.
Wow.
Brand new. Some kind of like a Taiwanese company.
That is pretty cool.
They 3D print the sticker.
Just perfect size.
I told him I know
what
I'm
over.
Okay, let me speed
up. Yeah. Okay.
Cool.
Sorry, Ryan needed to get out of the thing. Yeah. Ryan, this is an emergency. Emergency. Something's happening. What's going on?
Oh my god.
What happened? That's a. Oh shit, okay. He needed a hit. He's like, everybody get out of him. Woo! Yes, that's me. That's me. Very cool. Thank you. Jesus Christ. He needed to smoke so bad. Man, the vape. He needed the vape. Okay, guys. That's Brian's like, everybody, get out of my way. It's the. It's like. Oh, look at the room. He's listening. He can hear us. Yeah. Oh, shit. My rosé. I almost spilled the rosé. Don't spill the rosé. Is it too much? Yeah. Oh, hey.
Oh, no, we can take that one.
Yeah, you can take that one.
We got more comida coming.
Okay. Listen, guys, this was fun. Shout out to TGO1 for extending the live stream a little bit, extending the fun. I hope that we can keep this fun going tomorrow. Guys.
Nothing for the waitress?
Guys, we need $100 super chat before I end. I need it right now.
I'll do it.
Somebody has to do it. Don't make Eddie Mao do it. No!
It's our first day. It's our first
no.
day.
No.
Eddie.
No,
it's not for you. It's for her.
Dude. No, somebody has to save Eddie. Come on. $100 super chat before I end the live stream. It was a really fun day. I want to bring you guys more exciting live streams like these. Okay, Chelsea didn't like it. All right, Chelsea. I never asked you to super chat, but that's Ian Nicholson's burner account. I don't know why he has to come on as Chelsea. Oi, oi, Ian. Okay, cheers. All right, well, you didn't get the last super chat, but it's good. I like doing these streams for you guys. Wear your amazing watches. Support your friends, family, and I'll be back on tomorrow. Wow, the show continues. The show. Hey, that earthquake is the sign that big things are coming.
For the solar eclipse.
I want to go. If I
go to like, I think you can see in Pittsburgh.
Westchester. Westchester.
No, it's not going to West. Is it?
Yeah, that's what somebody said.
No, okay, I live in Westchester.
Maybe maybe we'll come. Maybe it's next to you. Maybe I'll come to you. Maybe we'll go together. Maybe this is it. This is why we were here.
This is holy dude.
Shit. Shit. Eddie.
All
right. We'll do the stream. Maybe it is. You gotta find a mask. Find a thing to wear. Oh shit. The tacos is here. I gotta. Whoa. Oh my god. The tacos, guys. They're bonk. They're more tacos. Three tacos for you. You guys are out of your mind. That's insane amount of tacos. This is an insane amount of tacos. This is so many tacos.
Don't spray.
Huh?
Watch out your rosé,
right? Rosé. Sorry. Yeah, this is crazy amount of tacos. So I'm gonna dive. Ooh, look at this. Feast your face. Tacos, guys. Tacos. It's a Taco Tuesday. Up on for the tacos. It's Friday. Oh yeah. It's a fun Friday night. Fun.
Fun day.
It's a Friday fun day. Cheers to the watch community. That's it. Peace out, everybody. I'm out of here. How did I end this? Oh, there we go. Shout out to Eileen and everybody who supports the show. Become members. Upvote.